our first ever Saturday morning Get Started Fast training webinar. We've got industry legend, our superstar trainer, Dale Calvert, here to train us today. He's got some great stuff lined up for you guys. So have your pen and paper ready. Get ready to take notes and take lots of them. Because there are not a lot of people in this industry that know more than Dale, that have done more than Dale. And that's the thing that I really like most about him, is he's not just the guy that, you know, has read a lot of motivational books and goes out there and tries to teach you those kind of things. This is a guy that's been in the trenches. He's been there. He's done that. He's built big organizations using the exact strategies, tools, systems that he's going to teach you guys this morning and that he's been sharing with us since he's been on board and been to a few of our conferences, both in Dallas as well as Cleveland. So, guys, pay attention. Take notes. Tim's still not with us, so I am going to turn it over to our main host, our special guest, superstar trainer, Mr. Dale Calvert.
Thank you. Thank you, Ben. I appreciate it, guys. Ben's got a lot more guts than I do. You aren't going to see my picture this morning. I got up. My wife says your hair looks like a rooster, and so it's not going to happen here, but he's got guts.
I'll turn that off so no one's distracted.
Okay, buddy. But I appreciate you guys being with us this morning. I've been excited about this for several weeks since we decided that we're going to do this. And this morning I look in my mind, there's two types of people. The majority of you guys have been with SBC for a long time. Ben, can you mute yourself out, because I got feedback on this end.
Yeah, let me try to do that.
That'll help. Yeah, I think that's perfect. And most of you have been around for a long time, and some of you have been maybe with SBC for 90 days or less, and you're thinking, you know, this is a great product, good people, you know, the weight loss market, that seems like that would be a great business, and you're kind of in the trenches figuring this out and wanting to get your business moving forward. And every month, you're going to have new people that will join your team. And the whole concept behind this training from this point on is give people, all those brand new people that are just getting started, give them a good, solid, foundational training that they can build upon. And that's the concept behind what we're doing with the Quick Start training. However, as we go through today, I realize most of you have been here for a while, and there's going to be some of this that you've heard, some of it that you're doing, but I'm hoping everybody will really have a paradigm shift or two as we go through this. But I want you to look at it, for those of you that have been around a while, through the eyes of a new person, because the plans are the first Saturday of every month to do a live Quick Start training and have different people do different segments. And I'm going to be talking to you as experienced leaders from time to time, but the majority of my focus is if you are a brand new person and just getting started and just getting going, so you can kind of see how all this comes together and see it through a new person's eyes. So we do want to welcome you. I promise you there's not going to be any fluff. This is myself. This is the best. I'm not going to show you how I'm looking this morning, but this is the actual picture of my wife and I. When we had the pleasure of being with a lot of you guys on the SBC cruise here in October. And just the first question you should always ask yourself when listening in on a webinar or seminar or conference call, in my opinion, is who is this person and why should I be listening to them? And Ben gave me great accolades on the front here, and I appreciate that. And that's really my background. I've been around the industry all my adult life. I actually started my first business when I was 14 out of my parents' home, which was a mail order business. Found the network marketing industry at age 20. First 3 years, I wanted to quit every day. It was the most frustrating thing I'd ever tried to do in my life. But finally, things started to come together, and they started to click for me. And, you know, we over 30 years, were with four different companies, and we started our own company, and we sold that company in 2000, and since the last 13, 14 years, all we've really done is we just train, and we consult, and we work with high-end, six-figure earners, helping them put together systems for their organizations and work with companies, and had the pleasure, Tim invited us to come and speak in Dallas at Jura's event about a year or so ago, and then Wendy asked us to come to Cleveland, and that led to us working directly with Ben, and we're really, really extremely excited about this relationship with SBC because everything's here. And you've got everything in place. You've got the right product, right time, great people in the field, awesome testimonies. And it just really fits everything that we believe in. And Ben is an owner that I've just loved working with. And I can't say that very often. So we get to work with who we want, where we want, when we want, and we are extremely excited to be here. I'm not going to give you a lot of fluff, and I'm not going to tell you what you want to hear. My goal this morning is to share things with you that I absolutely know will make a tremendous, tremendous difference in your business. And we still got people rolling in here, guys. This is awesome. We're going to have a great crowd. We're just getting ready to hit 600 here. We had over 1,100. People that registered, and we get, usually it's about two-thirds that come on a webinar, so we're gonna max this out before it's over with. So as you guys are coming on and new people coming on, we just want to welcome you this morning. First thing I just want to say is congratulations, you made a great business decision, and this is just an article I pulled off PR Web talking about the weight loss market, and just in the United States. And I've heard for the last, 15, 20 years, they'll say that the weight loss industry is a $60 billion, $70 billion industry in the U.S., and it has been for the last 15 to 20 years, somewhere between 60 and 70 billion. And the great news for each one of you is 15 years from now, it's still going to be a $60 to $70 billion industry. It's not going to go anywhere. It's not going to waver. People are always looking for ways to lose weight. It's going to continue. It always has been. It always will be. And it's just part of our society. And, a lot of people, it's just constant. It's something they do throughout their lifetime. And people are always wanting to hear about a hot weight loss product. And when people see people that get results, they always want to know what they're doing, how they're doing it, where can they get some. It's just a awesome, awesome market to be involved with. So for me personally, I look back and I think, my first 10 or 11 years in this industry, I was marketing products and services that people really did need. They needed them, but they didn't want them. You had to sell them. And the difference is with weight loss, people want weight loss, and it's a total different animal when you're going into the marketplace with products that people already want. There's already the desires there. You don't have to create that desire. And one of the articles that I read early in my career that really created this paradigm shift and has stayed with me ever since was an article in Success Magazine that said, if people want what you're selling, you'll get rich. And I'll never forget reading that because up until that point, again, I had spent all my time, energy, and effort marketing products that I believed in and I knew people needed, but they didn't want. So I just want to congratulate you guys this morning because you're in the right place at the right time with the right product line, and that's very important. And I just believe SBC makes sense. And people say, well, Dale, why? And, I've been talking to friends in the industry and people that I know, and just trying to, as I've been working with SBC, just trying to get a feel for the feeling out there. And a lot of people have seen it. They've seen the video, but they haven't really taken the time yet. They will, but they haven't taken the time yet to really investigate what's going on. And they say, well, Dale, why do you think that, it's such a great opportunity? And I tell them, number one is they have field leaders, you guys, who've already proven what's possible and who are still very active and excited and turned on about the future of the company, and they realize they haven't even really started yet and the company is still in its infancy. That's number one. Number two is Ben, if you guys have been around him, you've got an owner that understands that his success is based upon the success of SBC members. And that's critical because, unfortunately, I've been around and worked with, for short periods of time, ownership that, in my words, believe that the distributors are a necessary evil. And that's not Ben. Ben really, really understands and gets the fact that his success, the success of corporate, is based upon the, you guys in the field. And the third is you've already got the number one online recruiting system in the industry, and you've got, again, field leadership and ownership that have the desire to offer the best support structure and training systems that are out there. So I'm excited for you guys. I think you're in the right place at the right time with the right company. And I am just thankful and happy to be part of what's going on here. And I sincerely do appreciate the opportunity. It's fun to work with people that you like and that you believe in what they're doing. And if I can't, and it's hard for me to find those kind of people, quite frankly, because it's a different world out there. Now, today what we're going to cover is what I call the foundation for success. We're kind of go through your first six steps in this business, and we're going to share with you three concepts that you really need to become aware of and to understand and to learn to not fight it and to work with the way it is. And that's one of the hardest parts of this business. This business is very emotional in a lot of ways. And emotions end up taking people out of the business because they don't understand the processes. They don't understand that how to get through the emotional aspect of the business. So I'm going to share with you three very important concepts that you need to be aware of, not only so you can understand them in your own business, but you'll be able to help other people that are in the middle of these situations. And I'm going to share with you the first six steps. And then what we're going to do is we're going to come back. We'll take a little break, give everybody a chance to refill their coffee or whatever. Ben probably come back on, hopefully, and share whatever comments he would like. And then we'll take about a 3-4 minute break, and then we'll come back, and we'll get really into detail on the six steps in the actual SBC Retailer Recruit System. My first question, and this seems obvious, but it's really something that I think you need to really stop and think about if you're involved in this business, is do you want to fail or do you want to succeed? And notice that one of the options was not, do you want to try? And I think a lot of times people get involved in businesses like this, or they're kind of halfway serious, but they're not real serious, and they have not determined, you know, I'm going to make it here. They don't say to themselves, other people have done it, I can do it, I'm going to do it. And they kind of want to put one big toe in the water and, instead of just jumping in the pool and learn how to swim. And I want to encourage you guys, if you're going to be involved in this company, then jump in the pool. Because if you jump in the pool, the tools, the support, everything that you need to learn how to swim, it's here for you. There's no question about it. And what's not here for you will be here for you. But you already have more than you need to go as far as you want to go. Ben is committed to making it better and better for you guys, and I'm excited for you because of that. But don't put your toe in the water. If you're going to make it, you got to go for it. You got to decide, I'm going to succeed here. Failure's not an option. And unfortunately, in this industry, when people get involved, most people never make it in this industry. But you know what? Most people don't make it in whatever they do. Most people that get their license to become a real estate agent, and they go to school, and they get their training, and they get licensed through their state, most people that go through that entire process never list their first home. The same can be said about the insurance industry. Most people that get involved in the insurance industry, they go to school, they get their license, they go through all the state regulations, they become an insurance agent, then they'll end up selling three policies or less to people that they know, and they're out of that business. So it's not the network marketing industry, which gets a bad rap from that standpoint. And the reason it gets a bad rap is because you can get started in the industry with so little upfront investment. So it attracts a lot of people. The insurance, you don't have to pay several hundred dollars in licensing fees to get started in this business. But the reality is, most people who get started in something new never succeed. 50% join the day they get their, or peak the day they get their license in the insurance or the real estate business. 50% of the people that join a network marketing organization peak the day they get signed up. And I don't totally understand that, but I understand that's the way it is, and I can't fight it. There's no use in trying to fight it. 20% never really get plugged in. They never really sell themselves on what they're doing, on their product, on their company, on the people. And they go out and maybe they half-heartedly try to convince a few friends and family members to join or to buy in as it relates to the insurance or real estate business, you know, to get their house listed or whatever. You know, they go out half-heartedly with their big toe in the water and try to convince a few people, and when people don't join them immediately or get involved with them immediately in whatever their enterprise is, they end up quitting within 90 days. And then you can look at any industry, about 3% create personal financial success, and that can be said with the network marketing industry. And then about 27% of the people get the residual income vision, and they get committed, and they're loyal and they're dedicated people, but they have a limited financial success because they never really get their head under the water from a standpoint of getting in the pool. They're in the pool, or maybe they're sitting on the side of the pool with their legs dangling, but they never really say, you know what, I'm going for it. And daggone it, over the next 2 years, I'm going to give this everything I have. I'm going to do everything I have. So I'm going to give this two hard, solid years so I can do for the rest of my life what most people can't. They never really give it the time, effort, energy that it deserves. They never give that opportunity. And I can tell you, if you're part-time, which I'm sure most of you are, you can do this industry, you can do this business part-time, but you better have a full-time mentality. I believe network marketing, SBC, is about wealth generation. It's not about an extra $200 or $300 a month. There's easier ways to do it, quite frankly. The beautiful part about this industry and SBC and what you can do is the residual income. It's an industry that can give you time and money. You know, there's a lot of opportunities out there to create money, but you're not going to have any time. And there's some where you can have plenty of time, but you're going to go broke. You're not going to make any money. So the thing that makes this so powerful and more powerful than any other business model is the fact that it gives you time and money, but you have to have a vision for that, the lifestyle that it can give you and the time that you can spend with your family. But it doesn't happen for anybody until they see that first, until they're going for that. So the purpose of this training is really to increase your odds for success. I personally do not believe in teaching a lot of tips and ideas as much as I believe in teaching systems. I believe in systems because systems can be duplicated, and this industry is about duplication. It's not about innovation, it's about duplication. Teams can only be built through duplication. So again, we're going to share with you three concepts, your first six steps, and the question I would ask you is, how many of these steps are you going to follow? How many will you follow? And some people, and see, that's an important question. Because if you say I'm gonna follow all six, I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna follow all six, and most people will hear, they'll agree, and then they continue to do what they've always done. or they'll follow what's convenient for them or what's within their comfort zone. Growth only comes when you expand your comfort zone. And I really want to challenge you this morning. I want you to know you can do this business. You absolutely can. I'm going to prove it to you today that you can do it. But there's going to be, you aren't going to do it what you came here with. And if you do, it's not going to take you where you ultimately want to go. I think the first thing that we all have to understand is you're not the issue. Your team's not the issue. What's really the issue for long-term growth and financial residual wealth in this industry is understanding systems are duplicatable and a duplicatable system is. I love the acronym TEAM, and that stands for Together Everyone Achieves More. When you hear success stories of other SBC members, you should be thrilled because it just validates what you're doing. It's everybody, your day will come. Your day will always come. If you continue to do what's necessary to get where you want to go, your day will come. So everybody being happy and working together and viewing yourself as a team makes a huge, huge difference in this business. Now, the first concept, and if you're writing down the concepts, this is the first one, and it's a concept I call the pendulum. And you see this especially with new people. And as individuals, we're all made up of opinions, attitudes, and beliefs. So when you get started with SBC, you know, you probably get started because you have a pretty good opinion about the product and the opportunity, you know, but it's an opinion. And we all have opinions about everything. We have opinions about things we don't know anything about. We have opinions about stuff we don't even need to have opinions about. But we all have opinions, you know, like say it's like a belly button. So we all have opinions. And when you get started with SBC, you have a, most people have a positive opinion. That's it. And opinions can be swayed, and opinions can change from day to day. Opinions, you know, can swing back and forth. And, you know, some of you know I'm a crazy UK basketball fan, and, you know, unfortunately, the game last night, they played Baylor out in Texas, and everybody pretty much thought Kentucky would win. They were rated number 3 in the United States, and Baylor was number 20. And, you know, my opinion is they'll probably win by 8, 10 points, and they'll be okay. And they got beat last night. But about halfway, you know, through the first 5, 10 minutes, my opinion started to sway because I'm thinking, well, golly, you know, this Baylor team is tough. They're better than I thought they were going to be. But that's just one example, guys. Opinion, we all have a lot of them. And attitude is something a little bit stronger. It's a stronger emotion. We've heard the phrase, well, they've got a real attitude about that. And then a belief is something where you know what you know what you know, and no doubt is even can ever penetrate a belief. Opinions, attitudes, and beliefs. We're all made up of those three emotions. Most of us have way too many opinions. We have fewer, but we have some attitudes about things. And then a belief, most people can count their true beliefs on two hands. So we are all made up of opinions, attitudes, and beliefs. Now, when you get started with SBC, again, it's only because you have a positive opinion. But, you know, that could be today. Tomorrow, you know, somebody could call you and say, well, this product gave me diarrhea, or this product, you know, did this or did that. So our opinions are, it's a pendulum is swinging in our mind when we first started. And every one of you can relate to what I'm saying if you've been around for a while. When you first get started, is this going to work? Is this not going to work? Can I do it? Can I not do it? And this pendulum swinging back and forth and back and forth. But if you get plugged in and you get into the world and you become a product of the product and you do some of the things we're going to talk about this morning, the facts will back this program up. The people and the facts will back this program up. And what will happen for you, and I promise you this, your opinion will become stronger and stronger, your positive opinion, to the point that you'll get a strong, positive attitude about this program and what it can do. And if you stay in, because only time can grow this, and if you stay in and stay around and stay plugged in, that attitude, and that's what you want to do. You want to work towards belief. And see, a lot of times what we do, we get involved in this type of business, and we think, well, I don't believe this the way somebody else does. And we start comparing ourselves to people that have been around 6 months, a year, 2 years, that are making thousands of dollars a month or a week in income, and we think, well, something's wrong with us. We don't have that kind of conviction. Guys, it's a normal process. Don't fight yourself with this. Understand, you are working towards belief. Your pendulum's going to swing in the beginning. Don't let it freak you out. That's the number one concept when you get started. If you just stay around, stay plugged in, listen to your leadership, you will get where you want to go. There's too many people that have already done it, have already paved the way for you. Concept number two, this is very important. This is one of my favorite all-time quotes. It says, formal education will make you a living. If you become self-educated, you create a fortune. That's from Jim Rohn. Thank goodness I understood, and many of you have at an early age, that if average people with average intelligence have done it, then you can do it. You know, I would have loved to have been able to play basketball like Michael Jordan, but you know what? It wasn't ever going to happen. There's things in my life I would have loved to have been able to do, but the reality is it took, yes, dedication and hard work, which everything does, but it also took God-given talents. And there's some things that none of us will ever be able to do. I was never going to be a brain surgeon. Okay, the education, the understanding, the awareness, the desire wasn't there. Okay, so there's certain things, there's certain professions that take God-given talents and skills that you have to develop, and you have to have. You know, if I'm going to be a receiver on a football team like Julio Jones, and I need to be taller and be able to jump higher and have hands that can catch anything that are like magnets. And I use a lot of sports analogies because I like sports, but you guys understand what I'm saying. So formal education makes you a living, but if you become self-educated, you can create a fortune. I tell my kids, my grandkids, anybody that I can, look, if other people have done it with just average people, then you can do it. I don't care what it is. It just takes education. It takes practice. It takes perfect practice. That you can go wherever you want to go in your life. And you know, I had the slides done, and I looked last night. I was on Facebook, and I was, I got to put this in the presentation because it's what I'm trying to communicate. This is from Tim Miller, which all of you guys know, and. The picture says ICANN is 100 times more important than IQ, and that's exactly right. That's 100% right on. And see, what I have learned over the last 30-some years is self-made, successful people all come to the same conclusions. They all start to understand this wisdom of the ages, I call it. So you can too. You absolutely can too, but you have to understand some of this and get an awareness about it. And I hope that's what we're helping you do today, because you can learn this business. Guarantee it. Now, I'm going to prove that to you. How do we learn as human beings? Because, see, I see a lot of people involved in a lot of different business models, and it's like they don't remember how they learn, or they don't really understand how they learn. So they get involved with XYZ business model, and they're trying to do it with the skill sets and the mindsets they enter the business model with, instead of learning the skill sets and the mindsets that that have already proven success in that business model. And I'm not just talking about SBC. I mean, and again, we could be talking about real estate investing or any business model you want to look at. Most people try to accomplish and grow a business with the skill sets and the mindsets they enter the business with. It's a natural human reaction. Instead of understanding, there are skill sets and mindsets that other people who have become successful already have learned. And if I learn those skill sets and I learn those mindsets, then I can expect the same type of success. And some people grasp that, but they really haven't thought about how do I learn? How do I learn? Because, you know, let's face it, a lot of people get involved in business. They haven't been in a learning classroom environment in years, and they really aren't sure what they did when they were there. So how do we learn? As human beings, there's two ways we learn. How are you going to learn this business? Using these two ways. This is how we learn. Number one is through repetition, and number two is through emotion. And if you can, it's obvious when you say it, but it's repetition and emotion. So you can learn the SBC business. And I want to just prove this to you. And we'll talk about learning through emotion. Most of you remember where you were when you heard that Lady Di had died in a car crash. And the reason you remember that is because of the emotion that surrounded that time. So a lot of you remember that. You remember that time. Some of you remember where you were in 1987 when the stock market crashed. It was crazy. I can tell you exactly where I was when I heard it. I was actually in a little town called Ashland, Kentucky at the time. And eating in an awesome restaurant down there, mom and pop, and it came on the TV, and it's like, oh my gracious, you know. And the first thing you want to do is you start thinking, well, I wonder, you know, how this is going to affect me, and how many, I guess, all of my investments have tanked, and blah blah blah, and blah blah blah. But you remember that if you were involved in the stock market in 1987, if you're a huge Kentucky Wildcat basketball fan like I am. You remember 1996, the NCAA championship when they beat Syracuse 76-67. I was actually in the Meadowlands, sitting there mid-court watching that game. I mean, I'll never forget it. It was an unbelievable experience, being a lifelong Kentucky fan and be able to sit there and watch that happen. And so pick your favorite sports team, and when they won their last championship or when they could have and didn't, you probably remember that time and the emotions around that time. All of us, I'm sure, remember, you know, 9/11/2001. I'll never forget that day. You'll probably never forget that day. You remember where you were when you heard it, who you were with, the emotion around that time. Some of us are old enough to remember where we were when John F. Kennedy was shot, and was just recently, you know, the 50th anniversary of that. And, you know, that's one of my earliest childhood memories. I was 3 years old, and I remember that because it was a very emotional time for our country, and it was just shocking. So we all learn through emotion. So as you go through this seminar, if we go through this webinar this morning, or you go to a live event, there's very few things that touch you emotionally, okay? You can go to an event, and you can walk out of that event with pages of notes. But unless you go through those notes over and over and over and over, you're not going to get most of that information. The only thing you really walk out of an event from is something that hits you emotionally. It's like going to a sermon, and, you know, Jim Rohn talks about when he went to church, he would take his journal with him so he could write down notes. And he said people would look at him and look around like he's going to get out of here with some of this stuff. And, you know, but if there's something said that strikes us emotionally, we'll generally remember it. And that doesn't matter if we're listening to a CD or we're at a live event. We learn through emotions. And usually there's very few things in a seminar setting or webinar or conference call that hit us emotionally hard enough that we remember it. Example, I could say, well, what were you doing January 25th of 2011 or 2012? Most of you say, well, Dale, I don't have a clue what I was doing January 25th of 2011 or 12. You don't have a clue. Now, you know, we're approaching 800 people this morning now, and if we were in a crowd and I asked out of the 800, if I said, how many of you can tell me what you were doing January 25th last year? Out of 800, we would have about 1 or 2%, 8 to 10 people that would raise their hand in the crowd and say, Dale, I remember. And then I would ask you, I'd say, why do you remember? And you would say, well, it was my mom's birthday, and we had a surprise party for her. Or you would say, you know, my child had appendicitis, and we were in the hospital taking her appendix out. But an emotion would be tied to that date, and that's why you remember it. So we remember through emotion. And I use January 25th because I could probably tell you what I've been doing January 25th for the last several years. And you say, well, Dale, how in the world could you do that? Because it's my birthday. If I ask you what you were doing last year on your birthday, whatever the date is, you could tell me because, again, it's an emotional time. So we learn through emotion. The other way we learn, and this is the mother of learning, this is how most people are going to learn the SBC business, how they're going to master the SBC business is through taking good information, systems, and through repetition, making it part of you. You've learned through repetition your whole life, and a lot of times we don't even realize what we've learned, but we have it. You know, if I say flop, flop, fizz, fizz, oh, what a relief it is, you know, all of you pretty much know what I'm talking about. And it's been around for years, but I'm talking about Alka-Seltzer. Y'all seen the commercial. You know, some of you remember the commercial, I can't believe I ate the, you know how to finish it, the whole thing, right? Why? Because repetition, we heard it over and over and over. If I say two all beef patty special sauce, you know exactly what I'm talking about. The Big Mac, repetition, it's been programmed into our mind. If I say who shot, some of you that are as old as I am remember the show Dallas, who shot JR? If I say I shot, a lot of you remember the Eric Clapton song, I Shot the Sheriff. If I say I'd walk a mile for a, some of you remember that commercial, you're as old as I am, you're actually older than I am, I'd walk a mile for a camel. I grew up hearing that over and over and over in advertising. Where's the, you guys remember? Remember the little old lady? Where's the beef? The Wendy's commercial, they started to bring that back some last year. Where's the beef? So you learn, I learn, through repetition and emotion. And here's the thing, guys. You've learned all this by accident. We could go through thousands of things that are programmed in your mind that you've learned just simply because you've heard it over and over and over and over. So if you want to learn this business, you take the concepts, the ideas, what we're going to talk about earlier, the 3-day, 14, 29, 59-day call, and you do it over and over and over. And through repetition, you learn it. It becomes part of you. And now once you've learned it, you can teach it, which is critical. And you can build a huge, large, duplicating organization. It's easy to do, but it's easy not to do. And, again, the mistakes that most people make when they enter the industry is they try to do it with the skill sets and the mindsets they enter the industry with instead of learning the new ones that will take them where they want to go. That's what happens. Next concept, this is important. This is real important because it's not going to feel comfortable when you first start doing it. And, again, it doesn't matter if we're talking about learning the SBC business or any other business model. It's not supposed to feel comfortable. It's not going to feel comfortable when we first start learning. When we first start in a new business, in a new business model, a lot of times we're just excited and the emotion just carries us in the beginning. And all of you have experienced that at different points in your life. And you're in a state of being unconsciously incompetent. You don't know what you're doing, but you don't know that you don't know what you're doing. And you're just fired up, excited, you know. Jackie Stewart's made all this money, and I'm going to make this money, and I'm fired up, and this is going to change my life. And you get excited, and you get moving. And I've always believed that ignorance on fire is better than knowledge on ice. Ignorance on fire is better than knowledge on ice, and you're just fired up and excited, and you're moving forward, and you're unconsciously incompetent, and you're just going forward, and you're getting some results, and you don't even hear when people give you anything negative, or you're just past that. You're just fired up. You're in a state emotionally that you probably haven't been at very many times in your life, and you're just fired up. And you're unconsciously incompetent. You don't know what you're doing, but you don't know, so it doesn't matter, so you're just moving forward. And then over time, and it's predictable, you'll get to a point where you're consciously incompetent. And you wake up one day and you think, my gosh, I don't know what I'm doing. It's like I had 14 people that were excited. What happened to them? Where are they? What happened to them? You know, and you just wake up, and in network marketing, you have a beginning spurt, everybody does, and then you usually have a drop-off in the beginning. That's, if you look at the graph, that's how it happens. You have beginning spurt followed by a drop-off. And when you have that drop-off, what's happening is you're at a point of consciously incompetent, and quite frankly, that's when most people just say, well, this isn't going to work for me, and they quit. And they say, I got to find something else to do. And then they jump in another deal, and what happens? In the beginning, they're unconsciously incompetent. They're fired up. First 90 days, all this stuff's going on. Then they fall. And when they fall, they think, what happened? I had 12 people. Where are these 12 people? And they end up quitting because they're in a state of consciously incompetent. And then they go find another deal. And it's the same pattern over and over and over, except they go from 14 to 10 to 7 people to they had 5 people, and till now nobody listens to them, and they think, well, the network marketing just doesn't work. Guys, I've watched it for over 30 years. I've watched this pattern over and over and over. And with SBC, you got to get past this. And you got to help people get past it. And the way to help people get past it is to be aware of it and understand unconsciously incompetent. That's the way people are going to be in the beginning. Then they get kind of that down that beginning spurt, then it falls, and they're at a state of consciously incompetent. And that's when most people quit. And what we want to do, what the leaders and Ben and everybody, is help people from the beginning kind of have that excitement, but be at a point in learning something where from the beginning they are consciously competent. And what I mean is there's scripts there to follow, there's processes and systems in place where you can be fired up, but you can be working towards learning something that's ultimately going to create success. So you can start being consciously competent, and you can have everything in front of it that you need. And the goal and what will happen for you guys is one day you'll wake up and you're unconsciously competent. You can do this business in your sleep. You know exactly. Somebody gets started, first thing we need, 20 reasons, let's get 50 names going, boom, 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 boom. And you know this business, you know the processes, you know how the systems are in place. And at this point, once you have the systems and the foundation in place, then it just simply comes down to how many people can I run through the systems. But if the systems aren't in place, then you're bringing in a lot of people and you're running people through, then what is happening to those people is their ignorance on fire, they're unconsciously incompetent, then they become consciously incompetent, and they don't see the systems in place, they don't feel like they can move forward, they don't feel like the game plan is there for them, and they quit, and they're in another deal and another deal and another deal, and it's happened everywhere all over this industry, and it can end for you and for everybody that you enroll with SBC. And you guys have heard Ben say, I want this to be the last company people ever join. And he believes that. If I didn't believe he believed that, I wouldn't be spending Saturday morning with you guys, I promise you. Because that's how long-term success really happens. That's how you make a difference in other people's lives, long-term. And, I mean, it really fires me up to have people that get this. So those are the three concepts. Now, a wise person learns from their own mistakes, or a really wise person learns from the mistakes of others. And we just want to shortcut the system for you guys. We want to give you systems and programs that we know, the right mindsets, right skill sets, that will create long-term success for you. You know, people that, I mean, there's been so many short-term success stories as companies and as individuals in this industry that it's heartbreaking. And that's not what this industry is about. It's never what it's been about. It's about creating long-term residual income that will feed your children and your grandchildren and getting you there. And certain things have to be in place for you to expect that to happen, and that's what's happening here. You're an independent contractor. You can do the business however you choose. Some people are fortunate enough, about 3% of the population, when they enter the industry, they have the skill sets and the mindsets that will get their business going and moving forward. But that's only about 3% of the population. And you may be one of those people. The challenge that those people run into is everything that they do is not, it can't be duplicated by other people. They don't understand how special they are. They don't. They just think everybody can bob and weave and do what they do, and the reality is most people can't. Personality is not duplicatable, only systems are. So even when you're strong individually, that can only take you so far. Systems can take you, can help you reach your potential. Again, it comes back to this basic concept. Formal education makes you a living. If you become self-educated, you can create a fortune. And understanding, well, Dale, I came here and I had some great skills and attitude. Yes, you did, if you're one of the fortunate ones. But you have to understand, it's not about you. It's about what is it going to take to develop a team of six-figure earners. And the only way you can develop a team of six-figure earners is by developing those 27 percenters. So, again, I ask, do you want to fail? Do you want to succeed? If you follow the six steps, then you can expect your team members to do the same. If you follow them, then they're going to follow them. And what we're going to do is real quickly, I'm going to go through this part quick because we're going to get into detail in the next section after our break. But I want to cover these six real quick, and then we'll come back and we'll get into detail. These are the six beginning steps. Number one, you have to know why you're doing the business. It's really interesting. I was listening to something last week. I can't even remember who the guy was. But their whole business model is teaching people how to develop software programs, finding ideas for developing software programs, and finding people to develop those programs is a real complex business model. But, you know, I look at everything. I spend a lot of time every week. I have scheduled for, I call it personal education time. So I don't even know how I found these guys. It was not something, it's the furthest thing from my skill sets. But it was interesting. And I'm watching this guy, and he said, you know, we're going to give you the first video of this series on how to find people to develop software programs and blah, blah, blah. And his first training was, he said, you know, we've had a lot of people into this program and learning these software, how to create software programs. And he said, I can tell you right now what separates the people that make it from the people that don't. And he goes into 15, 20 minutes on knowing why you want to do the business. Now, he didn't say until you know why, the how doesn't matter, or I would have called him, but his whole thing was why. And if you look, I don't care what business model it is. I don't care what it is. I have witnessed this so many times over the years, because I believe the wisdom of the ages dictates that there's success principles and there's a flow. And I'm not getting, you know, out on a limb. I'm just saying, you know, I'm not. I mean, it's just the way it's been set up, that the people that make it are the people that have strong reasons for making it in any business. You know, probably 15, 20 years ago, I sit down and I took 25 of the six-figure earners on our team. And I looked at it and I was, what is it? What is the common denominator? Because we had housewife, plumber, UPS pilot, veterinarian, coal miner, restaurant owner, video arcade owner. And I'm looking at all these people with all their backgrounds. Did all of them have a small business background? No. And I'm looking to, you know, and the only thing that I realized was when they came in, they decided what they wanted from this business, and they decided, this is why I'm doing it, and I will not be denied. I am going to make this happen, period. And this is an opportunity. Other average people have done it. If they've done it, then I can do it. And I am not going to be denied. I am going to learn it. I'm going to become self-educated. I'm going to follow the systems. And and they just had a stronger determination to make it happen. And I can tell you that 9 out of 10 people that enter any business model never take the time to really decide why they're doing the business. They never do. And, you know, I don't want to have to, you can, this is wisdom of the ages stuff. Go back and find, if you can, find the Earl Nightingale, The Strangest Secret. If you can find that recording, and I'm sure you can, it's wisdom of the ages stuff. This was recorded back in the 50s, and it's talking about how only a small percent of the population has written specific goals, but those 3% that do have written specific goals end up accomplishing more in their life than the 97% of people that don't. Why would you want to mess with those odds? And see, I've talked with network marketers. They go, Dale, I don't have mine written down, but I can tell you what they are. They're right here in my mind. And I'll tell them, you're not the issue. You know, you're not the issue. Do you want thousands of people that have written specific reasons on why they're doing the business on your team? If you want that, then you have to model that, and you have to do it first. And those of you that have heard me, you know, in Cleveland, or I think I did this in Cleveland, and I told you in Dallas that I would. In Cleveland, I said, how many of you heard me talk about top 3 reasons, top 20 reasons? And everybody, you know, most of you had raised their hand. And I said, how many of you have them with you? Reach in your purse, reach in your billfold, pull out your reasons, hold them up, stand up. And I'll tell you right now, this morning, that the next time I have the opportunity to see you, I'm going to ask that question, because it's critical. It's step one. It's always been step one. It's not Dale's step one. It's wisdom of the ages stuff, guys. Wisdom of the ages stuff. It just is. And you just, if 3% of the people who write down why they're doing what they want, what they're doing, accomplish more than the 97% of those that don't, why would you want to be in the other group? Number two, get plugged in. Get plugged in. You know, you all have heard it said through your leaders many times, get in, stay in, plug in. So you want to listen to every corporate training call in the beginning. When you're doing the opportunity calls, three-way people in, let them listen. Let people listen in. And say, well, Dale, I can't get anybody to listen in on our three-way in on our call. Look, I need a favor. Can you help me out? I need a few minutes. Can I get a favor? Yeah. What do you need, Dale? I need about 20 minutes of your time. Can you help me out? Yeah. I need you to listen in on a call and just tell me who you know that I need to contact. See, the problem is we're trying to convince them to join instead of understanding the odds of them being any good if they did join is not very good, but they know somebody that could burn this business up. That's who you really want to talk to. And, again, we'll talk about this in more detail in a minute. Attend all the live events that you can drive within a day's drive. Ben and I talked and with some of the leaders, and we're hoping, I think that the next event coming up in February is in Raleigh, but next year there's going to be other events that hopefully you'll be able to drive to and come to, and you want to be there, guys. You just want to be at those live events. Become a product of the products. Use the products. That should go without saying. Become familiar with your back office and your tools. Your back office, guys, you have tools and things in your back office that other companies will charge $25 to $45 a month, and you have it free. And there's people on this call that have never logged into their back office, I'm sure. So get into your back office. Get familiar with what's going on back there. Number three, understand the recruiting process. Let the tools do the work. The less you say, the more money you make. Let your leadership do the webinars, do the conference calls, and just let people listen in and hear people that have already done it. Because if you say it, they doubt it. If somebody else says it, they believe it. I don't understand it, but that's just the way it is. Use that third-party power. So you basically send people to one of your many league capture page offers. You follow up. Are you open for more information? If they're open for more information, get them plugged into a conference call. Let them hear from your leadership. The less you say, the more money you make, and get help. If there's questions that come up and you're not sure, there's plenty of leaders that are willing to help you that you can get on a three-way call with. But don't get somebody on a three-way call and expecting your leader to sell them on SBC. That's not the way it works. Your job is to get them exposed, to get them on a conference call, get them to your website. Then once they raise their hand and they have some good questions, and maybe if you're not sure, then you get help with a third party and an upline. Don't expect your upline to call your Aunt Mary and sell her on the product. That's not the way it works. That's not getting help. We want to teach you and help you have the skill sets and the mindsets where you can do this business so you can help somebody else. It's not about doing it for you. It's about supporting you and helping you and giving you everything you need to move forward, because ultimately your success is based upon yourself, not on somebody else. So play one, get them to an online presentation. If they're open for more information, let them hear a webinar. A conference call, a Thursday night call, and you're ready to roll. Step four, this is real important. You're going to hear a lot more about this. We're going to talk about this in more detail and in a lot of detail. It's going to be in your new training manual. But step four is to announce your business to 50-plus people as soon as possible with a letter. And we're going to come back to that and get in more detail in the next section. Guys, it's get the emotions out of it. You're just planting seeds. If I opened a restaurant here in the Marietta, Georgia area, the first thing I would do is make a list of everybody I knew in Marietta, and I would send them a letter saying, hey, we just opened Dale's Pizza Parlor. I hope you can come by and try some of our pizza, and please spread the word for us. I mean, basic marketing 101, and we'll talk more about that in a minute. Again, don't worry about them saying no to you. Worry about them saying yes to somebody else. Let that one sink in. The worst thing in the world would be you go to Raleigh and they're recognizing new SBC members, and somebody that you went to school with or knew in the Raleigh area or in North Carolina walks across the stage because you never sent them a letter, you never contacted them. I've had it happen. Don't want that to happen. Okay, so after you've learned the systems, the basic foundational systems, and you get your first letters out, and don't even think about doing this till you've done the letters first, and we'll get into more detail on this in a minute, then you just, all it comes down to, guys, once the systems are in place, it's just running people through those systems. Don't try to run people through the system till you understand what you're doing. But once you've got everything in place, it's just, and again, I'll refer back to UK basketball because I'm such a big fan, as you guys know. But, you know, Calipari does a lot of, he's the best recruiter in the country, our coach. And a lot of the guys are one and done. They're here today and they're in the NBA next year. And because he prepares them for the NBA, that's what he does. So they come in, and the systems are already there. And it's just he's bringing people in, they're learning the systems, and they're ready to go play in the NBA. And that's kind of the flow. And once your business is set up right, then it's just a matter of bringing in new people, get them plugged in, and get them ready for the big time, the NBA, get them ready to lead other leaders, and boom, it's just a flow. And it just comes down to how many people can you get through your recruiting system. And there's multiple ways to create ads. And we've done some trainings for this, and there's some out there available for you guys that we've already done. There's going to be more in your back office. But we've talked about, and I'm not going to get into detail today on any of this because we've already covered all this, but the magic ad and drop cards and bulletin board flyers and safe lists and funded proposal book promotions, social media, trade show, safe list, online, offline, classified ads, and on and on and on and on and on. There's multiple ways to create leads, but it's not about creating a lead and creating one sale. It's about finding people that we can develop into leaders on your team. And the number one rule when you're in the cold market and you're doing these type of advertising, which I believe in, the only reason to prospect in the cold market is to get into the warm market of those you recruit. And if you don't write down anything we've said today, write that down. The only reason to prospect in the cold market is to get into the warm market of those you recruit, because that's how duplication happens really, really quickly. And we'll talk more about this in the next section. That last thing, step six, is never stop learning. Never stop learning. I just believe in that. And many of you are already members of our personal CD of the Month program, and I just want to tell you I appreciate that, and I hope you're getting a lot of value from, and I appreciate the emails that I get. The two first programs that I recommend should be part of every network marketer's library is What to Say When You Talk to Yourself. You can find that on Amazon probably for a penny. Shad Helmstetter, it's phenomenal book, and I love Jim Rohn, and especially Building Your Network Marketing Business, and that's awesome, should be part of your library for sure. And it comes down to this, guys: the right skill sets and attitudes plus the right opportunity equals the opportunity for wealth creation, and that's what you have with SBC, and you can do it. You absolutely can do it. Success comes from duplication, not innovation. What's going to happen to the growth of your team and your income if everyone plays it forward and follows the six steps we've talked about, and which we're going to get into a lot more detail about in the next section after our break? I hope that you guys are really thankful that Ben has made the effort and say, Dale, you know, let's do this first Saturday of every month for all new people, that they can get plugged in from the beginning and get consciously competent from day one, and you add that with their initial excitement, then it's going to create an ongoing excitement that's not going to go away because the path is in front of them to run on. I hope you guys are feeling what I'm trying my best to communicate this morning. Again, do you want to fail or do you want to succeed? And I'm asking you to make a commitment to yourself and your reasons for joining SBC. You know, I I love working with people and companies that I really, really know in my heart and soul, and that's gonna what's getting ready to happen as they move as SBC moves forward. The opportunity, guys, I can look any of you right straight in the face and say, if you will plug in and make the commitment, then everything that you want from your business and for your family and your future, I believe with everything within me, is possible with this company. I love being able to look you in the eye and tell you that. And I can't look you in the eye over this webinar, but if I could, I would. And because I believe that, guys. I believe it. So you decide why. You get plugged in and you stay plugged in. You say less. Let the tools do the work for you. Get through your warm market with your your warm market, and what we mean by that is your I'm open for business letters that we're going to talk about here in a minute, and get 50 in the market as soon as possible. I mean, just as soon as you possibly can. Never stop learning. Master at least 5 ways to create leads after you've gone through your initial foundational system, and commit to the process to learn the systems the right way. That's our morning section. I went a little bit longer than I expected, but what we want to do now, guys, is just take a short break.
2 minutes. Take a break. Dale's getting his coffee. This slide that Dale put up here, he's not supposed to see yet. Those numbers are not accurate. They were just put in there as fillers. But that's going to be similar to one of the pages in our in the GPS training manual at the end, just to show people that they can do it. But don't look at those numbers because they're not right. Anyway, have a great morning, everyone. We'll see you at the next break. And I'll let you guys go grab some coffee. I'm going to turn off my ugly mug here so you guys are not distracted and you really do go take a break. And we'll meet back here in about 3 more minutes. All right, go. Bye.
Okay, I think everything's good on my end. Let me make sure. Yeah. I was talking here for a few minutes and I realized I was on mute, so I hope you guys can hear me now all's well. I just get fired up every time I hear Ben talk because I know he's coming right from his soul, you know, and that's just so uncommon today in our industry when you look at corporate people, so that's kind of cool. What I wanted to try to communicate and accomplish this morning is let all new people, those of you who've been around 90 days or less, I just wanted you to know you can do this business, and the systems are in place here for you to learn, and you can accomplish whatever you want to accomplish. It's all right here for you, and you can do this business, and I hope you feel that. I mean, my gracious, if you know where's the beef, then you can learn how to do this business, and you can learn everything that we're getting ready to share with you. It's just repetition's the mother of learning, so I hope you're ready to roll. For those of you that have been around for a while, I hope you can see how this can take everything for your business to a totally different level. And, again, it comes down to success is about duplication, not innovation. In network marketing, it's about developing leaders, and that's the game. That's the ultimate game, and having the systems in place that can develop leaders. You know, you can go out and try to find leaders, but those people are hard to find, and the problem is once you find them, then they'll tend to not be duplicatable a lot of times. So once you have the systems in place, then you can create duplication, and you can start developing homegrown leaders. Game's over. You win, and you win big time. And, you know, we can learn that from companies like Starbucks. I mean, I can pull into a Starbucks here in Marietta, and they're going to say, welcome to Starbucks. What can I get started for you today? And I pull into a Starbucks in Houston, Texas, and they're going to say, welcome to Starbucks. What can I get started for you today? And if I pull into a Starbucks that we have in Georgetown, Kentucky, where I'm originally from, they're going to say, welcome to Starbucks. What can I get started for you today? It's the same thing. And why is it the same thing? Why is it the same terminology? Because that can be duplicated and it can be taught. That's the secret. That's the secret. It's like, how many times have we heard in McDonald's all over the world, after we place our order at the counter, they say, would you like fries with that? They all say it. Why do they all say it? Because then it can be duplicated. That's the power of a franchise. And when you take that concept, the franchise factor, and you add it to network marketing, which is very difficult to do, but when you do and you're committed to doing that, you can create something that separates SBC from all the other companies out there. Unity creates separation. When you unify your organization, you separate yourself from the masses. That's what makes the difference between McDonald's and Joe's Hamburgers. And let me get going, because I'll go off on that part. I could go off on that for hours. But let me move. So I'd like to welcome you guys back. Hopefully everybody's had a chance to get up and stretch and take a little break. And we're going to get into the system and the terminologies and the psychologies behind it. And, you know, a lot of times people are saying, well, Dale, really, what's the bottom line? How am I going to make money with this opportunity? Well, it comes down to developing and finding leaders. That's where the big money is going to come from. Your income ultimately is in direct proportion to the number of leaders that you have on your team. Okay, that's how big money is made in the network marketing industry. You're in the leadership development business. And, again, we're going to give you the systems and concepts and ideas and support structures to be able to do that, and that's the bottom line. So that's where your focus should be. And, you know, it starts here very easily with creating customers. And you want customers, and you know, your customer-to-business ratio is unbelievable as a company, and it's awesome, and all that's good. But, you know, you don't worry about the retail or the income you're making on the customer. I mean, the only reason, in my opinion, to sell a product in the marketplace is hopefully that person either becomes a future leader in your business or can lead you to a future leader. That's really it, because leadership multiplies. I can add a customer and add customers every day, add customers every week. I can add a lot of customers every month to my business. If I just wanted to do that, I could do that. And, you know, you can make great money doing that, several thousand dollars or more a month with SBC. And you can do that. But you're adding. When you find leaders and you develop leaders, it multiplies. And I would rather my business multiply than add. So, again, it's really getting this clear in your mind and understanding the game plan, what you're doing. And the bottom line, if you want to develop wealth and you want to develop walk-away residual income for your grandkids, it's going to be in relationship to not the number of customers that you have every month. And long-term and repeatable customers are very important. But the reason they're the most important is because they can lead you to future leaders on your team. Systems develop leaders. Systems, not personality. Systems develop leaders. And, again, you're in the leadership development business. Systems develop leaders. You know, and it's a matter of getting in, staying in, and plugging in, as we've talked about. All this information is going to be in your back office. Okay, everything that we cover, everything that we talk about on these webinars will eventually be in your back office. Some of it is now. Some of it will be later. I'm going to apologize to Ben in advance, because I'm probably showing you a couple of things that you're not supposed to see yet. Maybe you won't know that you're not supposed to see it, but Ben's going to know, and I didn't have the chance to. I apologize in advance, okay? I can't change it now. But there's some stuff coming that you guys, it's all about unity. It's all about conformity to the point that, you know, it's like when I go to a McDonald's restaurant, the cheeseburger wrapper is the same everywhere. So it's the same concept. Until it's all in the back office, I will have it on this website for you. Everything's already, it was done back in Dallas and still up, mlmhealth.com/SBC, but all this will eventually be in your back office if it's not already. It's all coming. The webinar replays and everything will all be back there. Okay. In this section, we're going to talk about how all success starts, why Skinny Body, the 100, and the SBC retail to recruit system. Everything starts with reasons and a system. Everything, all success, any business model. Until you know why, the how doesn't matter. You can have strong reasons and no system, and you can have some success. But if you're building a business model that requires duplication, then you have to have it built on systems. If not, you're always going to have to be there. And just give you an example. 2 weeks ago, I had a guy call me in a company, and he said, "Dale, you know, I've been following your stuff for a long time and blah, blah, blah." And the bottom line is it was a new coaching client, and he was wanting, you know, he said, "I need about 6 hours, and we're getting everything set up." And this guy's making a great income. Okay, but his team is not, he's the only one making any money, okay? He's doing awesome, but none of his people are. And, you know, in our first session, I'm talking and I'm saying, okay, well, I need to know what your recruiting process is. And he said, "Well, Dale," he said, "you know, I get people come in and I have them make a list of 500 people. And then I give them a time, and we get on the phone for 3 or 4 hours, and we're on a three-way, and I have them call the person, and they introduce them to me, and I tell them about our opportunity and what I've done and my story." And I said, "So if I'm brand new, that's what you want me to do, is three-way you in to people I know, and you're going to tell them our story?" He said, "Yeah." And he said, "I sponsor, you know, couple people out of 10 and I said, "What do those people do?" He said, "Well, that's my whole problem." He said, "Nobody's really doing anything, you know." And I'm sitting back, and I'm kind of in awe, and I shouldn't be, because I've seen this happen so many times. But I told the guy, I said, "Look, I'm gonna charge you for 1 hour consulting. The office is gonna refund what you've paid me, and I'm gonna tell you that what you're doing will never, ever duplicate, because it's dependent upon you and upon your skill set, and you happen to be sitting there at the phone." I said, "How many hours a week are you on the phone?" He said, "Well, I spend about 4 hours a night, 6 nights a week." I said, is that a lifestyle you want?" I said, "No." I said, "Okay." He said, "Dale, but it works for me." I said, "No, it doesn't work for you. It absolutely does. What does it work for? Because you're making an income. There's a lot of other ways you can go out and make six figures. Why, if it's working for you, why did you contact me? It's not working for. It's only working for you from an income standpoint, from a time, from a lifestyle, from a duplication factor. You're doing all the work, and if you're not there, it doesn't get done." And I said, "I want you to think about this. I'm going to send you some resources, go through some of this stuff, but you got to restructure everything you're doing." Now, guys, we don't want that to happen. And the way it's not going to happen is understanding reasons and systems. That's how it always starts. That's ultimately what creates success in this industry. So the first thing a person needs to do when they join, the very first, always has been, always will be, is decide why. And we'll have the forms in your back office for you. I've been talking about this for 25 years at least. And it's something, once I understood that this was always the first step to success, and again, it's all about wisdom of the ages stuff, guys. It was the first step 25 years from now. It'll be the first step 25 years from now. And it'll be the first step in your training manual, and it's up to you whether you decide to follow it or not. But, again, I definitely will hold your feet to the fire, and I believe your leadership will as well, because it is critical. And it's not about, you know, I don't care. Like I've had, it doesn't matter if you go out and your first week you move 15 bottles of product. That's awesome. Congratulations. It's phenomenal. It is. And some of you have done that and a lot more, and that's awesome. But why are you doing the business? Because until you know why, the how doesn't matter. Because you will, everybody wakes up one day at a state of consciously incompetent. It's going to happen. And you have to understand the first step always with every person that you enroll is you want them to take some time, sit down with their spouse or significant other, and I always tell people, you know, take a weekend, take a few hours at night, and just start writing down what things would make a difference in your life. What would you like to accomplish with the, well, I want to make more money. Okay, what do you want to do with the money? What specifically? Well, I want a new car. Okay, what kind of car? You know, not just a new car. I'd like this kind of car. Okay, what else? Well, we want some new patio furniture. Great. What else? We want to put aside money for our a college fund for our grandkids. Awesome. What else? And to figure out why. What do you want to accomplish? Because when you accomplish those things in this business, it magnifies everything. It makes everything so much bigger. It helps. And as a leader, I've heard my entire career in this business, I've heard people get up and quote, "You can have anything in life you want if you help enough other people get what they want." And some of you have heard me do this in different seminars, and I'll say, "How many have heard that statement?" And it's like everybody in the room. And I'll say, "Okay, now I want you to write down your five best people on your team. Write down their first name only. Nobody else needs to see it. It's just for you." How many of you got that done? Everybody raise their hand. I got it done. Okay, now, beside each person, I want you to write down the top three reasons that they're working your business. And people look at me like a deer staring in headlight. It's like, well, they want to make more money. No, that's not it. That's not the answer. That's incorrect. Why? Well, they want a new car, I think. No, if you're a leader, you know why your people are doing the business. And when you're around them, you're talking about their reasons. They don't care what you're doing. They don't care what your reasons are. They don't care that you just bought a new patio furniture. Good. It's what do they want? What are they working towards? You can have anything in life you want if you help enough other people get what they want. Now, I'll share a quick story with you, and we'll keep on moving, but this is kind of significant. This is years and years ago, but I was doing some direct mail postcard campaigns, and it was a long time ago. This is when you were doing one-on-one presentations around kitchen tables. And I usually tried to do at least five every Saturday because I was part-time. And I would schedule these appointments. And I had this one guy that just didn't sound very good on the phone. And he was going to be my sixth one for the day. And I had actually got up and worked from 6 in the morning to 12 noon at my regular job. And then I had all these appointments scheduled, and I was running behind. And I talked to him on the phone, and, you know, it's like, he lived way back in this apartment complex, and I finally found the apartment complex, and I had the wrong number written down, and it was just like, you know, this guy sounded lousy. I hate to admit it, but I just turned around, went home, went to sleep. I'd done five already. I'd sponsored two or three people, and I wasn't looking forward to talking to this guy anyway. And he called me that night, and he said, "What happened to you?" And he was, like, really upset because I didn't show up. And so I rescheduled. And I went back, and long story short, the guy got in my business, and he exploded it. And he just, I was just shocked. And you never know. I mean, you just don't know what's inside people sometimes. And he just really took off. And one of his top three reasons, and the thing, and he was young. He was like 22, 23, and he wanted a red Camaro. That was like his dream car, was a red Camaro. So we became close over time, and when I knew he wanted a red Camaro, we were doing a meeting a few hours from where we lived at the time, and I went by, and I said, "I want to pick you up about an hour or so earlier," because I knew where we were going, and I knew we were going to pass this Chevrolet dealership, and because we were going out kind of in the country, and this was in Kentucky, which is pretty much all country. We're going down in the country to do this meeting for these people, and I knew we were going to go past this Chevrolet dealership, and it was about 45 minutes from Lexington was the dealership, and we were going about 2 hours from Lexington. So we left a lot earlier, and he didn't know why, and I said, "Well, I just want to get you, we'll have dinner." Anyway, we went to the Chevrolet dealership, and we went in there, and we found the brochure that had a red Camaro on the front of it, and we had this red Camaro, and we took a test drive. We took a test drive, so we got in the car, and I said, "Bob," I said, it was just me and him, I'm in the front, he's beside me. I said, "Bob, I want you to smell this car. Just take it all in." And, "Oh, this is awesome." "Okay, now when you put that key in and you start it up, I want you to really feel it, okay? Because tonight I want you to think about doing this again when you own yours. And I want you to turn the key, and I want you to pay close attention to how that engine sounds." All right, and we went for our test drive. And as we're going through this test drive, I'm talking to him like that. I want him to absorb every minute of that. And then we come back, and I tell the sales guy, I said, I wrote down his name. I said, "Look, we'll be back in a few months, and we're going to pick this car up." And he said, "Yeah, sure." And he gave us a brochure, and I told Bob, I said, "Bob, when you get home, you put this on your bathroom mirror, and I want you every night when you go into bed, I want you to test drive this car in your mind. Just feel it, smell it, turn it on, and take it for a ride a few times." And every time I was around Bob, I'm talking about red Camaro, red Camaro, red Camaro. And he ended up earning the red Camaro, was his bonus car. And I got to take him back to that specific dealership to pick it up. And I could tell you story after story after story after story that's happened to me over my career, because I believe this guy. I believe what I'm sharing with you, and I believe that, I know that the 3% that have written specific reasons for doing a business accomplish more than the other 97%. And this is critically important. Why would you not want to have those odds in your favor? So the first thing we're going to do when a new person joins is we will ask them to take the time and figure out what they want from the business. And their top three reasons, there's a form, and you can put it on a postcard. And your top three reasons, you start with 20, and from those 20, what are the three things that you want to accomplish the most? For me, when I started, and I'm going to share this one concept with you because this is important, and this is important when you're talking with people. When I first did this, my reasons were, number one was to quit IBM. I wanted to be full-time. I wanted to quit. I was working at IBM in Lexington, Kentucky. I wanted to quit IBM. I wanted to have a new car, and I wanted to go to Hawaii. That was my original three reasons: quit IBM, new car, and go to Hawaii. And what I started to learn is through a lot of listening and to people that understood all this concept was the more specific these reasons are, the more compelling they are, and the more energy you get from those reasons. So my quit IBM, get a new car, and go to Hawaii changed. And what it changed to was my goal was to earn $5,500 a month. And this was 30 years ago, because I felt like if I could earn $5,500 a month, then I could quit IBM. Now, I really want to try to communicate the significant difference here, guys, because this is really a secret. The idea is your mind can, and this is worth writing down, your mind cannot work towards the reverse of an idea. Your mind cannot work towards the reverse of an idea. It won't give you energy. So what I'm saying is quitting IBM is a kind of negative go. But, okay, and that's my real reason was get to $5,500 a month, which is positive. I'm working towards $5,500 a month so I can leave IBM. Okay, so I hope that you see the significance. It's small, but it's significant. As you're figuring out what you want to accomplish, work towards what you want, not away from what you don't want. That's worth writing down. You have to work towards what you want, not away from what you don't want. So you work towards what you're wanting to accomplish. The second thing was I wanted a new car. Well, I had to decide what kind of car. And I did the same thing. You know, I finally went to the dealership, and this was like, golly, I'm going to date myself, but this was like 84. And I wanted that. That's when Mercury Cougar, some of you are as old as I am, and you remember they changed the body style to have that a lot sleeker looking car than the original Mercury Cougar. So I decided I want a Mercury Cougar, okay? So I'm working towards not just a car, but a Mercury Cougar. And then Hawaii, well, you know, we're in Hawaii. Did I want to go? I mean, I didn't know Honolulu from Maui at the time, okay? I didn't know anything about Hawaii except they have palm trees and beaches and warm all the time, and that's where I want to go. So I had to go to a travel agency, and I looked at Hawaii, and I thought about where in Hawaii and where do I want to stay in Hawaii and all of that. So it was Hawaii. So I want to go to Maui, Hawaii. So my quit IBM became earn $5,500 a month so I could leave IBM. My car became an 84 Mercury Cougar, and my Hawaii became I want to go to Maui, Hawaii, and stay at the Ritz-Carlton. So the more specific, and see, guys, energy comes from that. Why are you doing SBC? What do you want from it? You know, what do you want? What's pushing you? And it's really, really important. And if you can get pictures, it makes it even better because our mind thinks in pictures. If I say an RV, it's like, what kind of RV? There's all kinds of different RVs. Now, I don't want an RV, but you may want an RV. You know, what are you working towards? What are you working towards? What do you want? What do you want to accomplish? When I wanted to make $5,500, I took one of my checks from the company that I was with, and I scratched out the real amount, and I made a copy of it. And back then we had what's called whiteout, and I put it in a typewriter, and I made it from $1,200 a month or whatever the check was, and I made the check out for $5,500. And I took that check, which was a copied check. It wasn't, you know, the real check, obviously. That went in the bank. But I made a copy of the check, whited it out, made another copy, and made it out for $5,500 and put it on my bathroom mirror. And I'm looking at that. Guys, get real about what you want here. And see, some people are afraid to do that because they're, well, what if I don't make it, Dale? You will make it. Not making it is not an option. What the mind can conceive and believe it can achieve. You can't think about it if it wasn't possible for you. You cannot even imagine it right now if it wasn't possible for you. I can tell you guys with 100% confidence, the only reason that I have the privilege and the opportunity to share with you guys this morning is because many, many years ago, I took the time to write down specifically what I wanted to accomplish. Because if I hadn't done that, I probably would have never made it, personally. Because I was a top 70%er. I wasn't even at the 27%er level, much less a 3%er. And that's where your numbers are. You're 27, that's where most people are. Say, well, Dale, I don't need that. You're not the issue. You're not the issue. It's not about you. It's about building people. It's about touching people. It's about helping people move forward and progress in their life. And when you start teaching wisdom of the ages, stuff like this to your people, people reply, they respond to that. They understand that. Truth is truth, and people recognize it at a different level. It's not a bunch of hype. It's not a bunch of rah-rah. It's proven principles and wisdom of the ages. And again, I'm if you get the chance to, and most of you that have been around for a while, you've got somewhere, I mean, you've got Earl Nightingale, The Strangest Secret, somewhere. Pull it out. Listen to it. Don't violate those kind of concepts, guys. It's just too important. I actually, if you go in our office in Kentucky and you walk through, one of the things I have is that Earl Nightingale record label. The record. Like, some of you probably don't even know what records are. They used to play on things they called record players. No, I know you know what they are. But I got the record, The Strangest Secret. Not the cassette. This was before cassette. The actual record. And I've got the album and the cover. Huge. Framed, gold leaf, beautiful frame, hanging in my office with some other records of that time. Guys, it's just so important. And today, I've spent more time on this than I planned, but it's just so important. It really is. And it's to get the emotion attached to it. Get fired up about what you're doing, where you're going. And, I mean, the success stories with SBC are just, it's just awesome. I mean, you know, when we were on the, and I'll mention this, I promise you I'll keep on moving, but, you know, when we were on the cruise with a lot of the leaders in October, and just to hear some of the stories, I mean, it was awesome, absolutely awesome, what's happened here. I mean, the lives that have already been changed. I mean, think about the Kemps and buying the farm for their family, and she spent her last, you know, 70, 80 bucks to, and sold her kitchen table, or what, y'all have heard the story, to get involved in this company. And I could sit here and I could start talking about all of your stories and what's happened. And that's phenomenal, guys, but you understand what's happened to this point can be multiplied many, many times over. When that's your intention from the beginning, is to bring people in, figure out what their dream is, what are their desires, what do they want, what are their reasons, and then when your focus becomes on helping other people get what they want, when it really is, that's your focus. Forget what you want. Write it down, put it up, look at it, but that's not the, when you start focusing on helping other people get what they want, you will have anything in life you want. It's a law. The way it is. And a lot of people can quote it, but they don't live it. They don't believe it. They don't feel it with everything within them. Feel it with everything within you. Be value focused. Focus on helping other people get what they want. You're going to get what you want. It's just the way it's been set up. And we have the sheets for you. It will be in your manual where it can be part of the process. It is part of the process, and it's the first thing you do. Why ask anybody? If people want what you're selling, you'll get rich. You've heard that several times. That's originally from Success Magazine. Why ask anybody right now? Some of you have seen variations of this chart over the years, and it's not just in network marketing, really. It's pretty much in any business. It's you're looking at one side of what's commonly called the bell curve, which I know everybody's heard of. And, you know, it's debatable, you know, when is the best time to join a network marketing company and blah, 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 and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, the real answer to that, the real answer to the, when is the best time to join a network marketing company, it depends on what your reasons are. Because the best time has nothing to do with anything except what do you want to accomplish with that company. You know, if somebody says, well, Dale, you know, my goal is I just want to join network marketing for the personal development. I don't really care if I make any money, but I want to be with a company that I know is going to be here, you know, for a long time. And I just, you know, I just want to be a part of the culture and the environment and, you know, but I'm really not interested in creating wealth or whatever, or, you know, whatever, then, you know, what company should I join? I would say Amway. You want a culture and you want to be around the people and you're not really interested in making money and you really don't care if you spend more than you make, then go join Amway. So and I'm not trying to be, you know, I'm just saying it depends upon what do you want. I believe that network marketing has always been about wealth creation. It's not about a few hundred extra bucks a month. It's about wealth creation. And there's a lot of things that determine wealth creation. And one of the most important things is being in the right company at the right time in history. My first 5 years, I was with a company. It was an awesome company, awesome product, credible company. I believed in the product. People didn't need it, but people didn't want it. They needed it. And they had a product line that was ahead of the curve and ahead of its time, and there's a lot of good things. But, you know, guys, I started when there was only 10 network marketing companies or something in the whole marketplace. So I started, and I loved it, and I fell in love with the company, and I believed everything about it. But the bottom line is I joined in 1980, and the big money in that company had been made in about 74, 75, 76, because that's when they were in the momentum stage. Now, by the time I got in it, it was already in the stability stage, and that was fine. I learned a lot. I would never trade my time there, but the reality is the big money was already been made before I got there, okay? That's the reality. That's okay. I still did okay. You know, it got me out of IBM, so cool. The next company, and I've only been in four companies in 30 years, and I haven't been in any, you know, I retired in 2000. But the next company I heard about and went and looked at during this phase right here and came real, real, real close to getting involved, but I just didn't. I just didn't. And over a two-year period, it was like right here. When I joined, it was almost at the peak of the momentum. And, you know, I got to the top of the company in 18 months, and I saw it, you know, kind of move forward. But the reality is if I joined and I made, you know, six figures, you know, hit $250,000 a year there. But the reality is if I had gotten involved 2 years earlier, I would have made millions. I would have made millions. But that's okay because the next company, I was there at formulation. I had the skill sets, had the mindsets, knew what to do, knew how to do it. And lucky for me, I finally got involved in the weight loss industry. And for the first time in my career, I had a product that people wanted, not just needed. And the rest is history. It just exploded, made millions of dollars over the next few years. And it was because, now, it was because I was here and I got to follow all this. And see, when you look at SBC and people, you know, I believe, you know, some people say, well, Dale, we're in momentum right now. I don't think that. I mean, really? Really, where are you? I would say you're maybe you're at the beginning of this concentration stage. The good news is this formulation stage is when most companies go out of business. You guys are past that. Okay, the track record's here. The incomes that have already been created are documented. Ben's track record and intentions and the level of commitment that he has made to this business is more than evident. The formulation has been is in place. It's as solid as it can possibly be from every aspect. So this is the scariest part of being involved in any company. I hate that. I just hate when I see people get involved in companies here, especially if I don't know the ownership and the people running the deal. Okay, but if you can get involved here, and with everything that's being put into place and has already been put into place, the odds of this company at this point going from here to here is, I'm not going to say guaranteed, but it's really, really close. And the upside potential and where you guys can go from this point forward is staggering. It's staggering. So you have to appreciate where you are as a company. And again, if you've not been in this industry very long, or if you have, you really don't understand all this. And you can watch this, you know, you can watch these bell curves with anything. And it comes here and it goes here and it's stability. And then there's new trends and new technology. And see, I believe once you get here, I believe that the leaders in this company have the vision to, once new trends and new technology are developed, that they'll probably, you know, they'll make the news, the moves necessary to continue to ride the bell curve as new trends and new technologies are developed. And, you know, I just think that's where the focus is. So you're in a great place and the perfect timing to make this happen for you. Now, the $100 million retailer recruit system, those that master systems master their markets. Those that master systems master their markets. Network marketing, again, it's about duplication, not innovation. And some of you think, well, Dale, you guys keep saying the same thing over and over and over. And that's right. You know, I heard a story once about a preacher got up and he gave the sermon and he came back and the next week he gave the exact same sermon, and the next Sunday he gave the exact same sermon, and the next Sunday he gave the exact same sermon, and finally the board directors got together and he said, look, preacher, is it just us, or are you tending to say the same repeated sermon over and over and over every Sunday? And he said, no. I absolutely am saying the same sermon over and over and over. And they said, well, why are you doing that? He said, because I'm going to keep saying it till I know that you've gotten it. And I just want to make sure, guys, that you get these wisdom of the ages, and repetition is the mother of learning. So I apologize in advance, but it's, you got to get it. You got to really get it at a different level. And some of you are thinking, Dale, I've already gotten it. Okay, and I understand that, but you got to get it I want you to get it at a level that you've never gotten it before. I want you to feel it at a level you've never felt it before, because it really is the wisdom of the ages. And network marketing is not about duplication. It is about innovation. And systems are the key. And you or your team is not the issue. And I'm not, so you have to be, you have to understand and stay focused on what is the real issue. The issue is a duplicatable company system. That's it. That's critical. And then it's not about you. It's not about your team. It's about the SBC systems that the masses can get plugged in and can duplicate and move forward. And then once you understand the systems, and the only reason to recruit in the cold market is to get in the warm market of those you recruit, and you understand how to do that and how to help people get their reasons in place and how to help people get their open for business announcements out there, and you understand that process, then it comes down to how many different ways can you funnel people through that system. Critical. So the $100 million retail to recruit system, I believe all of you would agree that it's impossible for customers to get results on the product if they don't take it as directed. And the biggest challenge in the weight loss industry is human nature. And what happens is people take the product the way they're supposed to for 2 or 3 days, and excuse me, they get on the scales and they haven't lost 7 pounds in 3 days, and it's like, well, this isn't going to work for me. And, you know, they quit taking it as directed, and they don't drink the water, and they never weighed and measured to begin with, and it's just, you know, they're cynical and skeptical, and they just quit taking it, and it's like they don't continue to take the product, and they're waiting for the next miracle that they don't, you know, really what they want is just something where they can buy the bottle and rub the bottle and lose weight, where they don't even want to have to open it and take the cotton out and take the product to begin with. They're just looking for a miracle, and that's what everybody's looking for, and we have to understand that, and we have to learn to work with it and not fight it and do our very best, and that's all we can do. So we're going to do our very best to help people get results on the product and make sure they take it correctly, and that's all we can do. And as long as we've done that, there's still going to be a portion of the population that's not going to take it correctly, or it won't work for immediately, and they're not willing to take it for 90 days, and that's just part of it, guys. That's not going to change. There is no foo-foo dust to change that. All we can do is all we can do. As AOEM said, all we can do is all we can do, and all we can do is enough. And we have to do the best we can with what we have to work with. Customer follow-up is more important than the initial sale. Most people that buy a weight loss product never hear again from the person that sold it to them. That cannot happen with SBC. So I want to share with you a proven system that's going to help you make more sales and sponsor more members. That's what this SBC retail to recruit system is about, because the real money is made after the sale. That's where the real money is made, after the sale. Again, we're looking for people that ultimately can become our leaders in the future. If they buy the product once, they're a suspect. If they buy the product twice, they're a prospect. If they buy the product the third time, they're a customer. The best team members that you can have are people that were first great customers. They were customers first. Many of you listen to me today that are on this webinar with us this morning and giving up your time, effort, and energy on a Saturday morning. Guys, I appreciate you being here, by the way. And I mean, we've just added people since we started. We haven't even lost. It doesn't look like we're losing people. So that's good. That means you guys are serious. And the best people, there's many people here listening to us today. You started because you got started on the product and love the product. It takes most marketers several years to really believe and understand that follow-up's more important than initial contact. And it took me several years to really get it. And I'll be honest, you know, I just didn't get it. And most don't. And I've watched it happen. It's just kind of predictable. Most people really never think too much about follow-up, and they're more focused on the next sale than they are taking care of the customers that they have. And the way to make money in any type of business is you can make more sales sell more to existing customers or create more repeat customers. And, you know, most of the time energy, effort is made on that first sale. And once that's happened, guys, then good follow-up can, again, create great customers who ultimately can become awesome team members. And that's really has to be the focus for mature companies and mature distributors. And if you don't take care of what you have, then you end up losing hundreds of thousands of dollars in potential income because of the duplication factor. See, if you're not following up with people, then guess what? None of your team members are going to follow up with people. Leadership has to set the right example. So it's about follow-up, and follow-up is more important than the initial sale. Now, the SBC retail system, it's a step-by-step, word-for-word system that's going to help you sell more products and sponsor more members. We're going to do heavy follow-up in the first 30 days, because Number one, we want to make sure that they're taking the product correctly and daily. And so in the first 30 days, we're going to do all we can do to follow up and provide great service and let people know we're serious about them and we want them to get results on the product, and we know they have to take it correctly. So we're going to do heavy follow-up the first 30 days. Once they get results, we want to get referrals, and ultimately, if they're somebody we would like to have on our team, then we want to back them in the business using the number one motivation to man, which is fear loss. So how does it work? And again, there's going to be more in your training manuals about this. You're going to have more videos and a lot of information pounding this system over and over and over. And again, repetition, you learn it, you learn the terminology, and you've got it. You can master this quickly, very quickly. But again, it's deciding I want to do it, you know, deciding I want to master it. And, you know, if you start working at McDonald's and you refuse to say, would you like fries with this, and you continue to refuse that, then you're not going to be there very long. And just the way it is. If you aren't willing to follow the system, that system, the McDonald's system, then you probably shouldn't be involved in McDonald's. And I believe that with as it relates to any network marketing company, you need to be able to follow their systems. But the bottom line is, and the reality is most companies don't even offer any systems for their people. And those that do have the potential to separate themselves from every other company out there. See, I have no doubt that SBC is going to separate themselves from every weight loss product in the marketplace, in and out of the network marketing industry. And it's because unity creates separation. So the first thing you want to do when a person gets started, first thing, number one, is decide why. Until you know why, the how doesn't matter. You want to know why they're doing the business. You want their top three reasons so you can work with them and celebrate with them when they go pick up their first brand-new Camaro, or they pay off their house, or they take their kids to Disney World, or whatever they're wanting to do. You get to celebrate and experience that with them, because you can have anything in life you want if you help enough other people get what they want. Now, that's number one. Number two, always is we need 50 people that we can practice with. And 50 people that we can practice with. So there'll be a form where people can go in and they say, okay, Aunt Mary, my next-door neighbor, and we just say, open your mind. It doesn't matter, because all we're going to do is practice with these people anyway. And we just want 50 people that we can start with. And see, network marketing in general, the people that have the people that have worthless affiliate products to sell you, I'm going to say that again because I mean it, but the people that have worthless affiliate products to sell you will tell you things like, don't bug your friends and family, warm market's dead, are you a member of the NFL club, no friends left. Y'all seen it. It's everywhere because they tell people what they want, what people want to hear. They tell them, look, all you have to do is join this XYZ lead generation X thing, and you're going to have people calling you and begging you to join your business with their credit card in their hand, demanding that they join you, and blah, 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 and blah, and you've all seen it. And here's what I believe. I believe, in general, good people in the industry are absolutely sick of it. They're sick of it. You know, the seven lies of network marketing, and, you can't get people to come to events anymore. Events are dead. Well, you tell them that at wherever we're going in North Carolina, at Charlotte or Raleigh 1. Well, I'll be wherever it's supposed to be. But tell them that because there's going to be hundreds of people there, hundreds. So, guys, truth is truth. Truth is truth. And here's the reality. You walk into a room, and in that room is 10,000 successful network marketers, successful ones. Ask those people, when you were exposed to this business, when you first got involved in this business, who exposed you to the opportunity? 80 to 90% of the people are going to say a friend, relative, family member, business associate, someone that I already, someone that I knew. They didn't respond to an ad. They didn't get an email from wherever, a blaster. It was a friend, family member, business associate, somebody that they knew. Now, I can argue this on either side, okay, because my second company, the guy found me because I responded to a newspaper ad. Okay, so I can argue either part, and I believe in newspaper ads and online classifieds, and I've sponsored hundreds of people with that method. But what I'm saying is it's all about the odds, and the odds are most successful network marketers were exposed to the industry by somebody that they already knew. So when someone tells you to throw away your warm market list, they are lying to you. Now, I don't believe that you should call people and try to talk them into joining you in any business at any time. But see, they tell you that. They tell people, you know, stop bugging your friends. Well, if you were bugging them to begin with, you were doing it wrong. You were doing it wrong. You should never, you don't have to bug people. It's not about convincing. Amateurs try to convince. Professionals sort. See, so just because some, and people, see, I get what's going on. Again, it's people telling people what they want to hear. Stop bugging your friends and family. Well, if you were bugging them, you were doing it wrong. It wasn't contacting those people was wrong. That wasn't wrong. It was the way you were doing it. Amateurs try to convince, professionals sort. Now, granted, most companies, they bring people in and they say, go sick them. Here's the ghost. They get the go sick them training program. And it's like, Dale, nobody ever told me what I was supposed to say. I was just so excited, and I talked too much. And I just, yeah, we all do. Everybody kills a few. Okay, when you're starting any business, we all kill a few. We all kill a few till we figure out what we're doing. Okay? I've had people call me that I don't know. Last week somebody called the office, and it was a guy that I used to work with and years ago, and it was his son, and I respected his dad, and his son called. And I knew what was getting ready to happen when I called him back, but out of respect for his dad, I called him back. And I called him back and I said, you know, John Doe, this is Dale Calvert. I used to work with your dad. I know you called our office. I was just calling you back. And he started talking and didn't take a breath for it seemed like 25 minutes. It's blah, 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 your dad, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, oh, my gracious. And I said, look, I know the owners of the company. I'm not a prospect, but you need to get yourself some training. And I said, give me your address. I'm going to send you some stuff, and it will help you. And I'm done. Okay, that's happened over and over and over all over this industry. But just because people don't know what they were doing or were not trained or got excited and talked too much does not mean it's not valid. Okay, I'm going to keep moving now and get off that soapbox. But it's important, guys, that we understand this. So you want to start with people that we can practice with. We really honestly do not care one way or the other. If they buy, look, none of that matters. It's just like if you are opening a restaurant or any other business in your community. If you were going to start cleaning chimneys and be a chimney sweep, you would send a letter and let people know, hey, I'm in the chimney sweep business now. If you know anybody that needs their chimney sweep, please let them know that I'm in the business. Same exact traditional business concept, marketing 101. So, here's the letter. It will be, it's at the website I gave you earlier. It's going to be in your back office. It's very non-threatening. It's just good business. Step one, letter. Hello, the purpose of this letter is to let my friends, family members, and business associates know that I've started a part-time business from home, marketing a unique, one-of-a-kind weight management system with a dynamic company, Skinny Body Care. You place your website right there. Since being on the system, place your personal testimony there. That's why you want to be a product of the product. I feel great. I've lost inches. I've lost a few pounds. And really fired up about it. Whatever it is, you put your testimony right there. Now, next line. I need to ask you a favor. Can you help me out? Now, I want you to think about this for a minute, guys. If you get a letter from anybody that you know vaguely, and they say, hey, I need a favor. Could you help me out? What is the natural human response to that? Sure, what do you need, or how can I help you? Look, if I'm out in the parking lot of the mall and somebody comes up to me and says, hey, I need a favor, can you help me out? I'm going to at least see what they need. Now, if it's, okay, and they might need their car jumped or help jumping their car. And, I believe in being careful and being aware, but I also believe what goes around comes around, and if it's one of my daughters in the parking lot that needs help, I want somebody to be a good Samaritan and help them, so I'm trying to, I believe the yin and the yang, and you keep that what you take away. Okay, so I believe that most people have that underlying feeling. Now, granted, in today's world, you've got to be a lot more careful, and there's a lot of things we have to be aware of, but I believe it's a basic human nature to try to help people if you can. So when they say, I need a favor, can you help me out? If I know that person, then I'm vaguely know them, then I'm going to try to help them if I can. It's a human nature. I need a favor. Can you help me out? Please pass along the enclosed brochure to someone you know who's currently on a diet or wants to lose weight. Now, if you go to anybody in the United States and you say, do you know anybody that wants to lose weight or is on a diet right now, how many people do you think they could name in the next 5 minutes? Common. Everybody knows people that are on a diet or chronically on a diet or want to lose weight. Everybody does. And then the next statement, I know this system can help them, and they will thank you, and I will be very appreciative. Thank you for your time, and I appreciate your help. Respectfully, your name. Guys, is this simple? Is this simple? Is it non-threatening? And then you put, there's the brochure that you guys have, the 90-day challenge brochure. You put that in the mail, and you drop it in the mail to them. Now, when you send it, you know, I don't care what kind of address, return address the envelope has, but handwrite it. Handwrite it. Handwrite the address. So I say, well, Dale, this is just going to somebody at work. Can I just hand it to them? You could. But if you will start your business with 50 that you mail and you handwrite, versus handing it to them, you will get a much better response rate over the long haul. What I would do, if I say, well, I'm going to see them at work anyway, then I probably wouldn't put them on my business's opening letter list. Make sense? I might send this to somebody that I know in North Carolina or somebody a relative that I have in wherever, you know, people that I don't, not necessarily, but if I'm given the choice, should I send it to Uncle Joe in Houston or should I give it to the guy I work with, I would mail it to Uncle Joe in Houston. Because ultimately, guys, the name of the game is sorting through people and getting exposure to as many people as you possibly can. But this is a very structured, non-threatening, you're not going to talk too much way to get your message in the marketplace quickly. And you want to do 50 of these to start your business. Every SBC member should start with 50 of these to get their business moving forward before we worry too much about, you know, running an online ad on Craigslist or, you know, some kind of social media tactic or any other co-market type of recruiting. I believe in that. We need to do that. But what gives the most people the best odds to get their business moving in the right direction quickly. I mean, I was talking with someone a couple of weeks ago, and they were in another company, but they were spending 12 hours a day doing social media and Twitter stuff and all this, and they've been with the company over 3 months. And I said, you know, what kind of results is that getting? They said, well, I've already sponsored 4 people. And I'm thinking, 4 people in 4 months? It's like, who convinced you to do that? And I said, do you have relatives? Do you have family? Yeah. And so, guys, it's about getting people started quickly, correctly, and giving them good odds. And I'm not, and I do everything. I believe, do it all. But as a company, what's the best way to get new people started quickly and correctly and not talking too much and not wasting, you know, not thinking they have to have hours and hours of time to get their business moving quickly? This is simple. Once you have the letter saved in Word, you just change the first name up there and you're ready to go. You got the letter and brochures. You can rock. So now, step two. In 3 to 5 days, you want to do a real quick follow-up, real quick. And it's, hey, John, this is Dale Calvert. I'm just calling to make sure that you received the letter I mailed you. Did you receive it? Now, notice I say letter, not brochure. The brochure is in the letter, but I say letter. And let them respond. And most of them say, oh, yeah, Dale, I got that yesterday or whatever. Okay, I want to make sure that they've gotten it. And again, if the letter was hand addressed, there's no way it went into the mailbox or to the trash can. Excuse me. It didn't go in the trash can. If it's handwritten on the out front, they're going to open it probably the first thing, because you don't see that today. You don't see that. And when I do direct mail marketing, different business models, we use some direct mail, always handwrite it. I can pay people just to really handwrite envelopes. Okay, sorry. Let me get back on track here. So I just want, John, this is Dale Calvert. I'm just calling to make sure you see the letter I mailed you. Did you receive it? And let them respond. Shut up, let them respond. And they're going to say, yeah, Dale, I got it. Never will they say they didn't, as long as you give them enough time to get there. And if not, say, well, it's on its way to you. If they happen to say no, say, hey, it's on its way to you. You'll probably have it today or the next couple of days. I'll check back with you later. Have a good one, and I'm off the phone. Because they're going to say, well, what was it about? Why did you send me a letter? Get off the phone. Get off the phone. I'm not saying boo. They aren't hearing nothing. I got some other calls coming in. I got another call I got to make. I'll talk to you soon. I'll check with you in 2 or 3 days. Bye. Get off. 95% of the time, they're going to say, yeah. I'll say, well, great. And then the next statement is, who did you pass my brochure along to? Now, remember, the letter asked them to pass their brochure along, pass your brochure along. Now, 99% of the time, and my goal at this point, frankly, is they're going to say, well, I haven't had a chance, Dale, to give it to anybody yet. That's the response that I want. If I wait too long to call them, they may have already handed it out, which is okay, but I'm hoping that they're going to say, well, Dale, I haven't given it to anybody yet. I just got the letter yesterday. Hey, nope. Okay. And they almost kind of feel guilty here, guys. They kind of feel guilty. But, you know, so when they start, well, I haven't given it to anybody yet. I just got it. The next words out of your mouth is no problem, and pause. No problem. Let them diffuse. And it's like and you can almost feel it, like that. Well, Dale, I was going to, and I really wanted to, but I haven't. I just got it, and I just read it yesterday. And they're making excuses, and they're kind of at this level of energy, you know, making excuses. And you say, hey, no problem. And when they hear no problem, you can almost feel them over the phone going, good. They didn't let you down. That's the emotions that are happening. So you say, hey, no problem. And you got to pause here. And then you say, who are you going to give it to? And they will almost immediately say, my sister, my next door neighbor, a guy I work with. They will almost immediately say that because everybody knows people who are wanting to lose weight. Everybody. We all know people. Now, I want you to really think what's going on here, guys, because even if they got the brochure and the letter and threw it in the trash, which doesn't happen very often because people naturally are trying to help other people. But even if they threw it in the trash and you go through this sequence of these questions and you say, no problem, who are you going to give it to? They're going to tell you somebody, even if the brochure is in the trash and they had no intentions on doing it. They're going to say, well, my sister's on Weight Watchers or whatever. Okay? So I hope you all are following the flow of this because I'm telling you it works like magic, but you have to kind of understand what's going on. So they're going to respond, and then you say, hey, could you do me a favor and just pass the brochure along to somebody else, and I'll mail one to your sister. What's her address? Okay? I hope y'all, and they'll say, well, let's see. Her address is, and they'll give you the address. And I've got a pen, you're writing it down. Now, guys, I want you to think about what's just happened. You haven't tried to sell anything to anybody. You're a business person asking, you know, getting a non-threatening letter in the mail, letting people know, hey, I'm open for business. And then when you follow up, I'm telling you, this follow-up system has been refined and modified, and we finally got it down, you know, to where it's like, would you like fries with that? And we know that 70% of the people that ask that question are going to buy the fries. Okay, and I'm trying to, obviously, I'm giving off-the-wall examples here, but I hope you understand what we're trying to communicate, because it's very natural. It flows extremely well, and it's real simple. And once you got it, you just got it. And you can read it in the beginning, and it still works. So can you do me a favor and just pass this brochure along to somebody else, and I'll mail one to your sister. So now we ask them to give the brochure to somebody else because they know somebody else, and we get their sister's mailing address. So I hope everybody's following what's going on here. And so I appreciate it. When you talk to your sister, let her know I'll be sending a brochure. And I appreciate your help, Joe. And before I get ready to hang up, I'll say, hey, before I let you go, Joe, you wouldn't want to try the weight loss package, would you? And let them respond, no, not now, Dale, maybe later. Well, just, you know, that's fine. Just let me know down the road if you decide, you know, you want to drop a few pounds. I'm not saying you need to, but if you do, just remember me down the road, and I appreciate your help, and I'm off the phone. I'm not trying to convince them that they need to lose weight, that they need to try the product. I don't want that. See, the odds of the person we know being the person we're looking for is slim to none. But the odds of them knowing the person we're looking for is extremely high. I mean, if somebody called my wife and asked her, some of you have met Dawn. I mean, she's just tiny. She's, you know, tiny little woman. But one of her sisters is constantly on weight loss products. Okay, Dawn's not she probably is not a prospect. She would say she is, but she's not. But her sister is constantly doing something, so she would be a great prospect, and I've sent people to her before, okay? So that's the world, that's where we're at with this, and I hope you guys are seeing how, man, Dale, this makes sense. I can see this, how this will work. I mean, I wouldn't be offended at all if somebody called me and went through this or sent me that letter. I'm not going to be threatened. I'm not going to feel like, I mean, I'm cool with this. This works. I mean, I'm not threatened if somebody starts to are confused or or threatened or aggravated. Somebody starting a business and sends me a letter and lets me know about it and asks me to pass a brochure along to somebody, I'd be happy to help them out. That's the attitude that will be created with this. Now, step three, you pull out your 90-day brochure again and you say, hi, Jane Doe asked me, or whoever your original prospect was, asked me to send you this. She thought you might have an interest in trying our product. I'll call you soon. And you take a post-it note and you fold up your brochure and you stick it on the note, so when they open it, the first thing they see is the post-it note. Okay? Now, when you do this, you put your first name only. You don't put your phone number. It's a total curiosity thing. Okay? Now, if your brochure is stamped on the back and it's got your phone number and all that, that's fine. That's fine for this, for your referral, because, you know, they could read the brochure and say, man, I want to try this, and go right to your website. So you need to have your information on there. You can have your website. You can have your phone number, or both on there. But, again, what you want to create is just this whole curiosity concept. So you get this brochure in the mail with a post-it note. They aren't used to getting this. And then the follow-up calls real quickly. And we're going to 100% assume, since this person has been involved with multiple weight loss products probably, that they're going to want to try Skinny Fiber. We just totally assume that, because reality is they probably will. When you find people that like to try different products, and everybody knows people that try different products and different systems, when you can get this product in front of them, they're probably going to try it. It's just, the odds are very good. And that's where we want to play. We want to play where the people are that will use the product. So the follow-up, hey, John, I sent you, this is Dale Cowher, I sent you a brochure in the mail about the Skinny Body Care Weight Loss Package. Did you receive it? And let them respond. Don't say anything. Shut up. Did you receive it? Yeah, Dale, and I was getting ready to call you. Or, yeah, Dale, I was wanting to order that. And how much was it again? I want them to respond. I want them to say, you know, I'm just sick and tired of trying this stuff, or whatever. I don't care. I just want them to talk. Did you receive it? Yeah. Great. Glad you got it. What questions do I need to answer before we get you started on the package? Let them speak. Well, Dale, I it looked really good, and I was wanting to start. How much was it again to get started? I just want to let them talk, because it's going to tell you everything. Listen. If you listen, it's easy. Where we make mistakes in marketing is we start talking and we can't shut up, and we start selling. And when people feel like they're being sold to, they back away. People love to buy. They don't want to be sold to. So if we just shut up and listen, we can create all the business we want, because the market's huge. Now, what questions I need to answer for you before we get you started? I may answer one question. If I don't know the answer, I'll say, hey, I'm not sure about that, but I'll find out for you, and I'll let you know, okay? And then I'll just contact you should just contact your upline leader if you don't know. Answer the one question, and maybe they say, well, there was three ingredients in the product, right? And say, yeah, and answer the question, there was three ingredients, and this is how you end your answer to the question. The total for the package is only $59.95. Would you like to put that on a Visa or MasterCard? Now, for some of you, that statement and understanding how you answer one question and you end it, hey, the total for the package is only $59.95. Would you like to put that on a Visa or MasterCard? Learning that one phrase is going to get you so much business that you aren't even going to believe it. And say, what's that? No, Dale, I don't think I'm ready to order yet. Hey, no problem. I appreciate you. I appreciate you reading through the brochure. Down the road, if you decide you want to try the product, just let me know. You have a great day, and I'm out of there, okay? I am looking for low-lying fruit. You don't, if I'm not going to try to convince them to try the product, because if I get it in front of the right people, five, at least five, seven, eight people are going to try it anyway. And if I happen to get the one that's not, I'm not going to stress myself out or anybody else by trying to convince them to buy the product. I'm not going to do it. You don't need to do it. There's too much business out there if you just follow these scripts, follow this system, and roll through it, guys. And you're going to see where you're going to have more people than you can keep up with. Most of the time, over 50% of the time, if you ask that question at the end of an answer, you're just going to take the order. Okay. So, the SBC Retailer Recruit System, after you contact your initial 50 people, you get those letters out there, you're going to have multiple product sales and people to follow up with just using this, what I've shared with you. Some of the people that you send the letter to, they're going to want to try the product. Some of the people that you send the letter to, everybody, if you do it like we shared with you, everybody's going to give you a name. You aren't going to, there's nobody that's going to say, well, Dale, I don't know anybody who wants to lose weight. Okay. I mean, it's just not going to happen. I mean, people are, unless it's like, really? Really? You have a good day. I let that person go because it's just not going to happen, guys. Most people, when they're talked to right, you know, they aren't feel like they're bent. You know, just talk to people. Ask for a favor, just like you would want somebody to ask you for a favor. And if you do it that way, you're going to have more than you can keep up with. I promise you. And if you work the customer follow-up system that we're going to talk about next, you're never going to run out of people to talk to. So what I want to stop for a minute, and let's just take a break, and let's just process what's happened. We got started. We figured out why we're doing the business. We got our 20 reasons. We got our top three. We got them in our billfold, on our bathroom mirror. You put one in on your car, and on your visor. I don't know if I went through that like that, but you want your reasons up there. Now we want 50 people that we can let know that we're open for business. So we have the letter. We give you the exact word-for-word letter. You drop that in the mail. After you drop that in the mail with the brochure, you just follow up, and you talk to people exactly like you want to be talked to. Treat them the way you want to be treated, following the script that we've given you up to this point. Now, what's going to happen when this happens is you're going to have people buying the product. Okay, you will. And the next section, we're going to talk about how to follow up with product users. What we've talked about up to this point is how to start your business, get your letters in the marketplace, and get some sales flowing. This is probably a time, let me see. Yeah, we'll take a – this is going to be like a real short break, maybe just a couple minutes. Maybe Ben will come on and add his comments to this and tell me again that I showed you stuff I wasn't supposed to show you yet or whatever. But regardless, we're going to take a couple minutes here and just take a couple-minute break. Ben might come on. He might not. I might have made him upset by showing you stuff I wasn't supposed to show you. I don't know. But Tim might be on here. Anybody wants that on the monitor? Oh, here's somebody. Okay, buddy. let's take 2 minutes, okay? And because I want this up to this point to sink in for people before we move forward, okay?
Awesome.
Okay, Ben.
Great job, Dale. Hope everyone's doing awesome. I'll just sit here and talk for a few minutes. You guys can go take a break, get a snack, get some lunch, go to the bathroom, or watch me. But I hope you guys are really getting a lot out of this today. Dale is dropping some awesome information. And as I mentioned in the last break, guys, it's all about taking action on what you're learning today. Don't just take notes. Don't just sit there and tell me, hey, great webinar. Thanks for bringing Dale on board. This is so awesome. I'm so excited. And then not do anything. And it starts today. It starts right now. It starts right after this webinar. What's the first step? What's the first thing you're going to do today to take action towards your goal, to take action on what you're learning today? Don't put it off. Don't say, I'm going to start next week. Don't say, I'm going to learn all this stuff and then get it started. You learn by doing. You learn by taking action. So guys, put it in use. Put it to action. And if you didn't notice, most of this stuff that Dale's talking about, you don't have to spend $500. You don't have to spend $100. Most of it is free. Most of this stuff is stuff that you can do absolutely free. Take your business to the next level. And imagine if you had 100 people, 500 people, 1,000 people in your organization all taking action, all implementing these tools, these strategies, these systems that Dale's talking about today. If you had that many people in your team doing it, how fast your team would duplicate, how fast it would grow, how fast your check would grow, and how much faster you would get to that level of financial independence, financial security, long-term residual income, potentially retirement income that we talk about. So guys, I'm pumped. Big things are happening. Again, this is just the first step. So I'm going to stop talking now. I know you guys are watching me and not taking your break. So go take a break. I'm going to stop for about 3 minutes. And I'll come on one more time before Dale gets started here. And then I'll see you at the end. So you got 3 minutes. Go. And I wish you a good day. Hope everyone's having fun, and I'm out of here.
Thanks, Ben. Guys, we're going to go through. We're going to wrap it up. This is the last section. We've got customers now. We did a 50-50. We're open for business letters. Got those out there. We're getting customers now. So what do we do after we get customers? At the time of the sale, you want to tell people, make sure you weigh and measure. Make sure you weigh and measure, and I'll follow up with you in a few days and see how you're doing. So people say, here's my credit card, and then you can get their order placed. Or, sometimes they want to go online, do it themselves. Doesn't matter. But after they've got their order placed, you want to make sure at the time of the sale, you say, hey, make sure you weigh and measure, and I'll follow up with you in a few days and see how you're doing. Real simple. And about 3 days after they should have been taking the product, you want to give them a quick phone call. And the phone call is just real simple. And the first thing you want to tell them is, look, I don't want to take a lot of your time. Okay, because people are busy. They're busy. You're busy. You don't want to take a lot of their time. I was just thinking about you, and I wanted to make sure, you started on the product okay and you remembered to weigh and measure. That's it. I mean, I got it. I've been taking it every day, and I weighed and I measured and I got a good starting point. Okay, great. I'll check back with you here in a week or so, just see how you're doing. If you have any questions between now and then, give me a call and I'm off the phone. All you want to do, make sure they're taking the product, they weighed and measured, they know where they started. 14 days. Again, first question, I want to check with them on the phone real quick. 14 days, I say, hey Joe, this is Dale Calvert. I don't want to take a lot of your time. I just want to check and see how you're doing on the product. And then you just pause and let them tell you. And they've been on it about a half a month at this point. So I just want to check and see how you're doing on the product. That's all you say. You don't say, I want to check and see if you've lost any weight yet. I don't want to check and see, make sure you're still, I just want to check and see how you're doing on the product. Based upon their response, you're going to have one of two natural reactions, and you just know it's going to be fabulous, great, or you're going to need to encourage them a little bit. So it's one or the other. Okay, and again, all this has to be, it's to the point quick. You don't want to waste people's time, but you want to show them that you care about and you need to care about them getting results. So if they say, yeah, Dale, he said, I've already lost 4 pounds. I'm feeling better. I can tell my clothes are fitting looser. Then you just say, fabulous, that's awesome. Just keep taking it every day. And I'll check back with you here if you have any in a couple of weeks. If you have any questions, let me know. But awesome, glad you're doing well on it. And get off the phone. If they say, I can't tell any difference yet. I haven't had a chance to weigh, Bob. If they're kind of on that end of it, you say, hey, listen, it works. Some people lose it quick, some people lose it slow, some people it takes longer than others. The main thing I need you to promise me to do is that you keep taking it every single day like you're supposed to, and send them some encouragement now, or give them some encouragement. Say, I know people, because all of you know people that, took it for 2 months before they lost anything, and then all of a sudden it kicked in or whatever. I mean, and it's crazy with weight loss products, but give them some encouragement, get off the phone. And then you might want to send them some before and after pictures, or send them a story via email personally, at this point. It's up to you, but you want to encourage them at this point, okay? So we've done a 3-day, we've done a 14-day call. And by the way, just for your information, I'll make sure I don't forget this, all of this, these complimentary emails to your phone calls will be built into your back office follow-up system for your customers. That's the plan at this point. So that's coming for you guys. I believe in the first 30 days, every customer that you get started is worth a few quick phone calls. And if you'll take the time to do that, even if you have to leave a message, if they're at work or they don't pick up the phone or they're on another line, You can say basically the same thing. Hey, I just wanted to check with you, see how you're doing on the product. Give me a quick call back when you get a chance. And you'll usually hear back from people. Okay? But at least they know you're following up, and at least they know you care. And, and if it's your next-door neighbor, then they're probably going to, it just depends, guys. But, again, it comes back to you doing the best you can do, and everything else will be taken care of itself. You have total control over your business and the growth of your business, and you do. But we have to, we shouldn't expect extraordinary results if we're not doing our best in anything in life. So the 29-day call has also been called the money call. The 29-day call is simple. It's, hey, Joe, this is Dale Calvert. According to my records, it's time for you to reorder your product. How would you like to receive up to $10 off your next bottle? And here's my thoughts on this, guys. I would invest $10 all day long to get people. I would invest $1 per name, and to me it's worth the $10 investment that we're going to be talking about. Now, so I'm just going to go with this, and Ben and I went back and forth on several ideas on this, but as I think about it, and let me continue to work you through what we're doing here, because you suddenly say, well, Dale, in the comp plan, I only make $1, or I only make what? Why would I give them 10? And I understand that, but I also understand business, and I also understand that, marketing and the power of referral and all the other stuff that you're going to see. And to me, it does make sense. But we're just going to go with this right now, and I think you'll see what we're talking about. So don't get hung up on $10 at this point. That's what I'm saying. So according to my records, it's time for you to reorder your product. How would you like to receive up to $10 off your next bottle? And I don't do up to emphasis like that on the phone. I'm just doing up to emphasize to you guys. So what do you think their response is going to be? See, even if they've taken it and they know they haven't taken it the way they're supposed to, and they've missed a few, you know, days here and there, and maybe they haven't had fabulous results yet, if you're going to offer them $10 off their next bottle, the odds are, because these people ideally are people that are used to taking products and being on weight loss systems, the odds are that they're going to take you up on that offer. How would you like to receive up to $10 off your next bottle? They're going to say, well, what I got to do to get $10 off? That's usually the next question is, well, what I need to do. Okay. Here's how you respond to that. And this is important. This terminology is important. For every name that you give me, hey, Joe, for every name that you give me that I can send a brochure to, I'm going to give you a dollar off per name up to 10. So for every name you give me that I can get send a brochure to, I'm going to give you a dollar off per name. When you think about this, guys, it's not for everybody that you give me. It's not for everybody. Every name that you give me that I can call and try to sell my product to, or blah blah. It's, hey, every name you give me, I can send a brochure to. I'll give you a dollar off per name up to 10. And people don't have any problem with you mailing a brochure to their next door neighbor or to their sister. Okay, so it's no big deal. For every name you give me that I can send a brochure to, I'll give you a dollar off per name up to 10. And then we'll have a little form that you can email them, and they fill in their name, their address, city, state, zip, the email of each person. And for every name, it's up to 10. And I've done this and taught this for years, and I've never had one person that's given me 8 names or 7 names. It's always 10. Everybody that we've taught this to, and I've talked to them about it, it's always 10. Because people can think of 3 or 4 or 5 real quick, and then they've got 5 names there. They'll add 5 more people that may want to be on a weight loss product because they want to maximize their $10. They want to make sure they get the full 10. If they happen to give you 7, then it's $7. That's the game. That's the agreement. So every name you give me, I can send a brochure to. I'll give you a dollar off per name up to 10. So now they've sent you ten names, and you can work that however you want to work it. If you want to rebate them, whatever you want to do, that's up to you. But you know, you want to follow through and do what you say you were going to do. But now I have 10 people, 10 more prospects. What are those people going to be worth? I know out of 10 that 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 are going to end up buying. I know that. So I'll give a dollar all day long for a quality referral, all day long. I will buy all I can buy if I'm in the weight loss business. Absolutely. If I'm SBC and I know what I'm doing and I'm working it and I don't mind working and I'm not expecting, you know, to sit there and watch TV and make money, and I'm willing to work and do my part, I'll give a dollar per name all day long. So the follow-up call, what we do with those 10 people is we take the brochure and we put a note on there. Hi, Jane Doe asked me to send you this. She thought you might have an interest in trying our product. Call you soon, Dale. And you drop that in the mail. And let's say I sent it to somebody named Mark, and the follow-up call is just a little bit different, but it's the same concept. It's, hey, Mark, this is Dale Calvert with Skinny Body calling you back. Jane Doe had asked me to send you a brochure about our 90-day challenge. Did you receive that? And they're going to say, yeah. And I'll tell you what happens, guys. Here's what happens. They get the brochure. You know who they call? They call Jane Doe. That's who they call. They say, hey, Jane, I got some brochure from a guy named Dale about some skinny body 90-day whatever. Are you taking this? Now, Jane is going to talk up the product because it makes them look good. And I could get into all of this from a psychological, and I'm not going to, but the reality is when Mark calls Jane, say, Jane, somebody named Dale sent me this brochure, and it's about something called Skinny Body. Are you taking this? Is this legit? And she's going to make it sound good because it's like, oh, I'm sharing. I'm taking it, but I don't really like it. Well, then why did you give me that? Why did you give tell them to send the brochure to me? That's not going to happen. See, so Jane's going. She's going to be saying, yeah, I told them to send you the brochure because I've been taking it. I really like this. I think it's a great product, and the company's good, and he's a nice person or whatever. See, Jane is going to really sell it for you because she doesn't want to look bad. And if you think that through, you can understand how that happens, and that's what happens. So did you receive it? Yeah. I'm going to follow up with Mark. Hey, Mark, this is Dale Calvert, Skinny Body, calling you back. Jane Doe asked me to send you a brochure about a 9-day challenge. Did you receive that? Now, I know the odds are he's already called Jane and Jane's already sold him or said good things about us. That's the odds. Usually that's what's happened. Did you receive it? And they're going to say, yeah, I got it. I even talked to Jane about it. And I said, great, what questions do I need to answer before we get you started? Well, Jane seemed to like it, and I'm always looking for new products, ways to lose weight, so I don't really think I had any questions. And they usually, how much was it to get started? It was like $59.97. Would you like to put that on Visa or MasterCard? And we're done. We've got another customer. Okay? It's real simple, guys. It's real easy. It's not uncomfortable for you, and it's not uncomfortable for them, and that's what we want. You know, and if they say, well, you know, I just don't think I want to try. Hey, no problem. No problem, Mark. I appreciate you taking a look at the brochure. And if you decide later on that you would like to try the product, let me know. And in the meantime, would you please pass the brochure along to somebody that you know that is serious about losing weight right now? And you just don't put any pressure. It never is worth trying to sell the product because there's too many people that want to buy it if you just get it in front of them. And see, I can't say that about most products. You have to learn how to sell, not weight loss. It's a totally different game. You just have to get it in front of the people. So your goal from those 10 names that were originally given to you, that you gave $1 per name, from those 10 names, you want to start a minimum 2 to 4 new customers as soon as possible. And that is very, very doable, and I would even say highly likely. Over time, as you get more comfortable and this gets into your comfort zone, and it's just like, would you like fries with that, and you understand it, then you can get to a point where you can do 5, 6, 7 just because you're so comfortable and you expect people to do what's in their best interest. And, you know, and you don't care if they don't. Now, let's look at what's happened. We've got 2 to 4 customers from the referrals we originally got from Jane Doe. Jane got started on our product. Maybe she was one of our 50 open for business letters sister. Who knows where Jane come from? But Jane got started on the product. We followed up with Jane, 3 days, 14, 29-day call. At the end of 29, we asked her, hey, Jane, how would you like to receive up to $1 off? How would you like to receive up to $10 off your next order? And she's going to say, well, what do I need to do? For every name that you give me that I can send a brochure to, I'll give you $1 off per name up to 10 names. She said, oh, that sounds good. I sent her the form. She sent it back. I've got now 10 name addresses, phone numbers, and emails of people. I've sent them all 10 a brochure, and I followed up, as we've just discussed. And from those 10, let's say we enroll 4 people. 4 people get started on the product, okay? Now we'll go back to Jane, and I actually put Tammy here. This should say Jane. This is the 58-day call to the original person that we got started on the product. So that person, we got them started. We followed up professionally. At the end of 29 days, we got them started on another bottle of product, and we got some referrals from them. Now it's their end of their second month. So we call this the 58-day call. And we'll just call her Tammy since that's what this says, but you all know the person we're talking about. So I say, hey, Tammy, this is Dale Calvert. And again, during the second month, I haven't called her one time, okay? I do heavy follow-up the first 30 days. Once the second order is purchased, she knows how to contact me. She can contact me if she would like, but I just let her take the product, okay? And if you want to, you know, just to check in, that's fine, but it's – but we haven't, and it's not really part of the system. This, because the key is always the first 30 days to get people taking it consistently. So, hi, Tammy. This is Dale Calvert. I just want to check, see how you're doing on the product. It looks like it's time for you, about time for you to order again, and I can't give you a discount this time, but how would you learn how you can make some money with this product and get it free? And they're going to say, what? How would you like to learn how to make some money with this product and get it free? Now, they're going to say, well, what do I have to do to that? What do I have to do to do that? And then here's the next question is real important, and I've got to expand this for your back office. But the next question is, it's not, well, I need you to come to this. I need you to go here. I need you to call into that. Okay, I need you. You don't want to go there, okay? Really listen. I cannot give you a discount this time, but how would you like to learn how to make some money with the product and get it free? Well, how do I do that? Okay, they're going to ask that. Here's what you say. Write this down because I don't think I have this on the overheads. Is what are you doing Thursday night? What are you doing Thursday night? And they say, well, I don't think I have anything planned necessarily Thursday. And then you say, well, I'll tell you what, I'll call you about 5 to 7 or 5 to 8, I'm not, you know, whatever time your Thursday night call is, and I'll three-way you into a company conference call. It'll explain everything and answer your questions, and you'll learn how you can get it free and make some money. And all you want to do then is just three-way the person in. Again, guys, the less you say, the more money you make. This is a – and I see somebody say, well, Dale, I could sign them up right now. I could get them started, get them going. I could do all that right now. Okay. And I know you could. But, again, guys, it's what can be duplicated by the masses. Can a brand-new person that's been around 2 weeks, could they do that? Probably not. So let the tools do the work for you. You'll make more money in the long run. You'll duplicate faster and quicker. So if they say, well, Dale, I don't know if I want to listen to a three-way. I don't know. I don't know if I want to listen to a conference call. If there's any kind of objection at all, you have leverage here. And this is always, they say, well, Dale, I don't know, blah, blah. You know, I say, look, no problem. No problem. But you remember those 10 people you got them? That you gave me? Yeah. Four of them have already got started on the product. Do you want to make money from them or do you want me to? And I'm willing to give those people, and what we're doing here, guys, is I'm willing to give those people away to get that person in the business if they're somebody I really like and think has tremendous potential. So we're using fear of loss here. And it's like, four of those people are already on the product. They're going to make somebody a lot of money. It might as well be you, but I need you to get on this webinar so you can see if this is something that makes sense for you. And boom, you're back in the business. Now, yeah, you know, we'll have all this available for you where you do your 3-day, 10-day, 3-14, 29, 58. And after we've taken somebody through this process, we're either going to put them in the business, we're going to scratch them off our list, or they're an eagle file. Maybe the timing in their business is, the timing in their life is not right now. Maybe they've got, you know, life happening, things are going on right now. They like what they see, they see the potential, but the timing's not right. Put them in your eagle file. And you'll hear more about Eagle File down the road. But so everybody that you bring in is 3-day, 14, 29, 58, sponsor, and how do you sponsor them? You get them exposed to the whole story. That's key. Always, people, until they see the whole story, they haven't heard. And the less we say, the more likely we are to get them to the corporate call, to let them hear the whole story. After the call is over, by the way, it's just the same question we've been asking the whole time throughout this system. It's, hey, Joe, what questions do I need to answer for you before we get you started tonight? And you get them enrolled as a distributor, as SBC members, and they can start doing the business. And what do they do once they join? Well, the first thing is 20 reasons. What's the next thing? Top 50 names. Are y'all seeing this? And it's the same foundational system over and over and over, and systems can be duplicated, and that's the deal. That's the deal. So we're going to bring them through. They're either going to join, not join. If they don't join, no problem. No problem. No problem. I'll put them in my Eagle file if I like them, and when I go to the meeting in North Carolina, I'll send them a postcard from North Carolina. I'm going to stay in front of them every 90 days or so. I'm not going to bug them. I know the timing in their life is going to change, and when it does, I want them to think of me. And if I just don't like them, I don't think I would work with them, then I just scratch them off my list. I either scratch them, they join, or I put them in my Eagle file. And I hope you see how this system can supply an ongoing flow of new prospects to share the SBC opportunity with, because you got 2 to 4 people started originally. And let's say you follow up on that person and they say, nah, I just don't think I'm interested in making money or getting the product free, but I would still like to go ahead and order the product. Let them go order the product. But you have 4 people that they gave you. What are you doing with those 4 people? 3-day, 14, 29-day, 58. Would you like to learn how to get the product free and make some money? So you got 4 more prospects. From those 4, let's say 1 joins. From those 1, what do you have? You got, what are we going to do with that 1? We're going to do top 20 reasons. We're going to do top 3 reasons. We're going to do 50 people to start your business with. And, guys, it's the same duplicatable, welcome to Starbucks. What can I get started with you today? Would you like to supersize this? It's the same flow every time with everybody. And that flow creates unity, and it creates power, and it will separate SBC from every other company out there. And once you have the basic foundational system in place, it's just how many people can you get through the systems on a daily, weekly, monthly basis, and that all comes from all the different lead generation methods that you can learn through this company and through the leadership in this company. Now, I'm hoping you're seeing. I'm getting fired up now. So can you learn this? Yes, you can. You absolutely can learn it. You can learn it word for word, concept by concept, system by system. Repetition is the mother of learning. That's how you're going to learn it. And since success comes from duplication, not innovation, I hope you can see how this will give your new members a track to run on from day one that they can learn and then in turn teach to others who can teach to others who can teach others. Will your results get better as you work towards becoming unconsciously confident? Absolutely. Absolutely. And there's not a person on this call today that within month, 2, 3 can't be totally unconsciously confident with this system well enough to teach it. And see, the thing about it is everybody that joins your team, everybody will know whether you're plugged in to what the SBC system or not, because they're going to know what you did with them. So there's no hiding here, and that can intimidate people, and that's okay, because the unity that's going to be created over the long haul will totally separate this company from every other company out there, and ultimately is going to attract people to SBC because they know if I join these companies, they've developed a lot of leaders. They're bringing people down the road. They're helping people grow as people. They've got an awesome product and a hot industry. And this is, if I join here and get started with these guys, then I will be able to reach my full potential. And that's what people, I believe, are ultimately looking for in today's marketplace. They're tired of all the junk that's out there and all the BS and the hype and telling people they don't want to be told what they want to hear. They want to be told, hey, you got a chance here. You can change your life. You can really do something special, and we've got the track for you to run on to make all those reasons that you have for ever even getting involved in a business a reality. And I know what this has done, because not just from a personal standpoint, I mean, I've shared with you guys the foundational system that has helped me to, you know, help me develop $100 million in product sales in less than 5 years. But this foundational system, I've seen work over and over and over in and out of different business models, not just in network marketing, but in the retail environment and other environments. And it's the people that are willing to take the time to give customers the support and appreciation they need can ultimately turn those customers into business partners. And implementing this system is going to give you the opportunity to maximize your profit in your skinny body business. It's going to help you make more money and absolutely enroll more members. And when everybody's plugged in, everybody's going to benefit more in the long run. Guys, I appreciate you being here today. We went a little bit longer than I had anticipated, but I hope that you've gotten a lot from this. You're going to hear so much more about this. Again, it's going to be part of your training manual. It's going to be talked about. And again, the goal is putting together a very unified, cohesive organization that just flows. And when new people come in, they understand this is how we do it. This is what everybody else is doing. And it eliminates people trying to find the magic foo-foo dust, which is not there. You know, people spend all their time trying to find, well, what's the secret? What's the foo-foo dust? The secret is systematically get your product and service and opportunity in front of people. And how you do that only can be done when it's systemized. So I appreciate the opportunity to speak with you guys. I know what this was going to do. I hope you guys, everybody that you enroll this month, you make sure they get plugged into next month's Quick Start training. And some of you think, well, Dale, is it going to be the same thing? Yes. Yes. It's going to be the same thing, being taught by different people. But it'll be the same thing, because it's always, would you like fries with that? Unity duplication doesn't change. It grows and it works and it duplicates, and that's the name of the game. It's monotonous and it's boring, and it's not a new red wagon to play with every month, but it works, and it's been proven to work over and over and over, and it stood the test of time. And that's really what all of us want, is a business that will stand the test of time and will feed our children and our grandchildren, and everything's in place to make that happen. So, Ben, I'm going to turn it back over to you, let you wrap it up. I appreciate people being with us and excited about getting this in the marketplace.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Dale, and thank you for doing that call and for teaching us everything. That was awesome. I'm seeing Facebook posts and messages going all around, emails, how pumped up people are. So thank you so much for doing that. Hope you guys got a lot out of what Dale shared with you today. Hope you have a lot of notes there. One thing I want to say is, don't get overwhelmed. There's a lot of information shared with you guys today. The awesome part about it is you don't have to do everything right out of the gate. Just pick a few of the strategies and systems that Dale talked about today. Start with those. And once you master those, move on to the next one. This isn't a race. It's not how fast you can build this thing. It's how stable, how long-term, how consistently you can do it. Just do those little things, as Dale was talking about, every single day. And the more of these systems, the more of these strategies and tools you implement into your game, into your business, the faster it's going to grow, the more ways that you have leads and customers and distributors coming into your organization, the more duplication you have. And as I talked about at the last break, the more people in your team are going to see that you're a leader. You're going to lead by example. And the team, the speed of the team is the speed of the leader. If you guys are out there doing it, proving that it can be done, that it's easy, your team is going to see that. They're going to want to be just like you. They're going to want to do what you're doing. And again, if you want your team to be doing these things, you need to be doing them. It's really as simple as that. So guys,
thanks so much for joining us. I hope it was a productive Saturday. I definitely think it was. I think you guys got a lot out of it. I know with everything that's happening in 2014 with our TV show, our distributor kits, our customer kits, our pay-per-view video, a few other surprises we haven't even announced yet, and all this training, the leadership development, guys, it's about to go huge. So we are super excited, and I tell you what, I mean, I talk about this a lot, but it's really, you know, we are a team. This isn't just me. It's not Dale. It's not Tim. It's not just the leaders. This is a whole group, a whole family of people coming together and absolutely rocking this industry. And guys, we are making it happen big. The little guy is winning. A lot of times for the first time ever, we're helping the underdog, and it feels good. And we are absolutely dominating and just taking names, kicking tail in this industry, and we're going to keep it up. So thanks so much for joining us today, guys. But again, don't get off this call and say, oh, wow, that was so awesome. I loved it. I'm so excited. I'm so pumped up, and then not do anything. The key to making this happen is to go out there and put it into action. Put it to work. Make it happen in your organization. Even if you just do one thing, one tiny thing that you learned today, do something and start it now. And as Dale talked about first at our first break, next convention, we're both going to ask you, you know, who's got their why list? And if you don't have your why list, how can you expect your team to bring their why list and know what their reason is and what they're shooting for, why they're in this business? And ask your team. It helps them when you know their why. It helps you help them. I hope that makes sense. If you know what their reason is, when they get frustrated, because everyone, as Dale talked about, it's not always easy. A lot of times it's monotonous. A lot of times, you know, you'll think you have a leader in your organization, and then they go jump to another deal thinking they can make some more money over there. Guys, things happen in this industry. And so when you know people's whys and you know how to help them, when they get frustrated, when they get down, they have a bad day, you can say, look, this is the reason you're doing this business. You want to get off your job. You want to be able to support your family. You don't want to have to live paycheck to paycheck. You want to be able to take care of your kids, send them to college, buy a new house, not have to worry about money all the time, get out of debt. Whatever your reason is, guys, or whatever your people's reason is, you need to know that. And you need your upline to know what your reason is. So when you have a bad day, they can tell you, hey, this is why you're doing this business. This is what it's about. Is it worth it? Is it worth it to put in a little bit of extra effort today to make it, really, to set yourself up potentially for life? And guys, the truth is, absolutely, it is. And we want to make that happen for you. I talk about it all the time, but I truly, sincerely, with 100% of my being, want this to be the last company you ever have to be involved in. We're going to keep giving you guys training, systems, support, tools, everything to make sure that that happens and to give you more than you could ever imagine, more than any other company out there in the industry has, because we want you to make it. And that's our commitment to you. Hopefully you guys can see that. Hopefully you can share our vision. We can't wait to see you at the top. You guys are absolutely awesome. Go out there, take action. Have an awesome Saturday. Have a great weekend. Have a great week. Have a great month. And I can't wait to see you guys in Charlotte in February. Goodbye, guys.